Hey guys, this is Cotton Grammar and Derek Wasiak. Welcome to another assimilation webinar. We're going to spend the first hour questions and answers, and then we're going to go into some crazy lessons we have lined up for you the second half. And I think you're going to enjoy them immensely. How's it going, Derek? Know that I see that Derek's muted, so we might take a little bit to say hello. And we'll just wait for him. But while we're waiting for Derek to say hello, our special guest is really someone that everyone knows quite well. Hello, special guest. How are you?
Hey, Cotton. What's up, man?
Who's this?
It's your good buddy, Mr. Floyd.
Guys, Stephen Floyd's going to be joining us tonight, as he has the last 3 weeks. So,
big surprise.
he has an amazing topic lined up tonight, and we're going to hold that under wraps. I've been excited to listen to it myself. He kind of explained it to me a little bit over the last couple days, and I think it's going to get some hashtag mind blown, definitely. So with that, we're going to get started. Guys, if you can hear me good, give me a one in the chat box. Fantastic. And guys, I want to hear some feedback. How is Mobile Apocalypse working for you? Are you getting any feedback, any sales? Love to get some feedback on like how things are working for you with that. We deployed last week showing you how to fix it with Dude Mobile. We've also showed you how, you know, email is effective. We're going to cover another key piece of that tonight. But if anyone has had any income reports or anything from it, I'd like to know that we've seen some people have success with it. Guys, if you've been having a great time with this, and if you've been finding that it's been easier to open up to your clients, give me a number three. If you guys still want some more information about how to get clients to respond to this, give me number five. A lot of fives. So, Stephen, it looks like the general consensus is people's having a hard time selling this. At least from there, that seems a little unusual to me, doesn't it?
Yeah. Is there anything you can do to help, Cotton?
I think there is, and I think we're going to go over that. I like see some things here said no replies yet, but every day I send out 50 emails. There's a lot of people. It says, Cotton, can you go over the fix again or will it be posted? Guys, for us to go over the fix again, you can just rewatch the webinar. So we're going to go into that a little bit deeper. Guys, if you've got any questions about the mobile update, please ask. Derek, whenever you get back or if you're back, please like say hello.
Hey, Cotton.
Yes.
Can you unmute Derek, please? He's back.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that he couldn't. There you go. Derek, can you hear me?
There you go. I'm not an organizer. I can't
unmute myself. Oh, hold on. Let me make you an organizer. Hold on. There we go. All right. We got that taken care of. So any questions you guys have for Derek, Steven, myself, either on the doorway, the Google doorway page update or Mobile Apocalypse, client getting, anything like that, let's get the questions lined up and we'll just jump right into questions right now. We're going to first go with Norman. And Stephen, he says he's still not clear. What is the difference between responsive and mobile friendly?
Yeah, you know what? That's actually, over this on the webinar, but it's really, really a common question that we get a lot because frankly, there's a lot of misinformation on the internet about it, mostly on sites, like WordPress groups and stuff. So the difference between responsive and mobile is, what responsive websites do is they take your existing content as is and they resize it to where it will fit onto different size devices. So, you have your website and it squeezes it down or makes it bigger or skinnier or fatter or whatever it needs to do to where display, semi-well on any device that it's viewed on. So that would be a responsive website. If you have a really good looking website and it shrinks down well, then, that can be really good for you and it can work out for you. But a mobile website technically is not very much different. But it is going to give a presentation that is significantly different. So on one of the webinars, if you'll watch, I think it was the last one that I did, I showed you kind of a screenshot, a side-by-side of what it looks like. And so, you know, if you think of a mobile website, think about, you know, if you've gone to a site and you pulled it up on your phone, and what it shows is probably like the logo at the top of the page, and there's probably like a call now button, right, like a click to call. And then there's just two or three other choices normally, right? All it does is it gives you just the choices that you need to be able to, you know, make a transaction or to contact the company. So, you know, your website may have, you know, 30 or 40 things to click on, for example, right? If they go to your home, you know, you may have all kinds of tabs and menus and services and locations and all kinds of stuff. But someone that's searching from a phone doesn't need all of that information, and they're not going to take the time to search it. So a mobile site doesn't simply resize it. It actually restructures. It takes the important parts of your site, and that's determined by you. You determine what parts are important, what parts are going to lead to a conversion for you, a phone call or a form fill out or whatever it is. And that makes it where, you know, your conversions are just, honestly, they're going to go through with a true mobile site as opposed to most responsive sites. And there are some good responsive sites. But, you know, when you, if you were on your phone and you were looking for, let's say you wanted a massage appointment, all right, and you type in, you know, Dallas Massage, right, and a site pulls up and you go to it and you click on it and it's responsive and it's a typical responsive, you know, it may or may not be easy to find the phone number. The phone number may or may not be clickable, and there may or may not be an easy way to make an appointment, right, or a map, right? But if you find one that's a site, then when you pull it up, then 99% of the time, the click-to-call button is right there. And it's active, and then usually there's like a map that you can click on right there. So it just, the user experience is so much better, and that's really the reason why Google is doing the update in April, because mobile sites give much better user experience to the end user. And of course, that's what they want. They want people to find what they're searching for when they use the search engine.
Great.
So I hope that makes sense.
Makes a ton of sense to me. That was the most explanation of, and the most thorough one I have yet to ever hear, so hopefully there'll be no more questions on what the difference is, and it made it very, 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 very clear. The next question is Google My Business citation question. On my Google My Business, my address is 123 Army Boulevard, Suite A. My postcard says 123 Army Boulevard, STEA. I heard that Google uses Suite as number A. What do I need to do here? Change my Google business page. What do I put on my citations? I haven't verified yet, Stephen.
You want me to take that one?
Go ahead.
Yeah. So not too long ago, probably 3 to 6 months ago, that may have been a big issue for you, but Google has gotten a lot smarter since then. So what's typically going to be in your best interest, whatever Google thinks or whatever your address looks like on the Google My Business page, so if it's shortens it, which it does sometimes. Whatever it looks like on that page is what you're going to want to build your citations out to, and what you're going to want as the NAP, the name, address, phone number information on your actual website. So it's not so important what it says. It's important that the three are consistent as much as possible. So if you verify your address, you know, sometimes you'll log into your Google My Business, and Google may have changed slightly the way that your address is presented. So when it does that, you can call Google Business Support and see if it can be fixed, if it's not an issue with like a number of characters. But it, you know, it really doesn't matter. So the thing is, if Google My Business says ST, or if it says STE or whatever it says, then use that as the foundation to build your citations and your actual website information that should match it.
Great. Great answer. And we'll move on to the next question. Chris says the snow stopped. Now we have Luke. Luke says Mobilepocalypse. He said, I sent out emails to 750 prospects, not a single reply. Not moaning, just saying that this is kind of ineffective. Any ideas on how to capitalize on Mobilepocalypse without an existing bank of 331 past, present, or almost clients like you had? And I'll tackle that a little bit, and if, you know, if Derek and Stephen want to jump in, then they're more than welcome to. It all comes down to, first of all, what are you sending? Sales copy. You know, the copy of that email address and the titles are quite important. Second of all, I am going to show you tonight how I am able to pull cold prospects from email. So we're going to dip into that a little bit later tonight. So with that, what I want to tell you guys is, if you think that I'm pulling clients from a cold text email, no. Business owners do not respond to that. You can send out emails, but cold, just black and white text emails do not work. And I'm going to show you what I've been doing to get success with it. Now, once again, when you're cold calling through email, you have to run through numbers. You always can't expect that you're going to get a high amount of people call you back unless you have something engaging them, unless you have something that's standing out that's different from someone else. So with that in mind is, I want you to stop and think. If you're a business owner and you get something that comes across and you click on it, you know what the first thing I do when I click on an email and I see black and white text and there's too much of it, or there's not enough that's going to capture my attention? Move on to the next one. So we're going to go over that a little bit later tonight, and I'm glad that question was brought up. We're going to show you how to get your emails. I guarantee you that this will increase your open rates. This will increase the amount of people that are going to be responding to you dramatically. It has for me. I've like tested it since then. When I first started doing this, I don't wait very long before I come up with solutions that I know that are better. So we're going to go over that a little bit later. You guys have anything you want to add to that, or?
No.
Okay.
It's just, it's hard to even get past the promotional box in your spam box too. Mm. So.
Sure. And we're gonna discuss that a little bit later. And it says, is there any way to configure Jetpack mobile theme to show a different homepage? Mine is just showing where someone could leave a comment. The rest of the site works fine. I haven't messed enough with Jetpack to know. Steven, do you know? Guess Steven's not with us.
Oh, his internet died. He's rebooting.
Oh, got it. Yeah, yeah. It says he's offline. We'll wait and come back to that question we've got here. Jetpack is a quick fix. I've like never used it to fix my client sites. I've just used Duda Mobile. So I haven't messed enough with Jetpack to give you an adequate response. So I mean, Derek, if you mess with Jetpack enough, you can answer it. Have you?
Yeah, I really don't use it at all. I stick to the personally, and I just add. I have a few plugins to add click to call on there. That's about it.
Right. Got it. We'll just come back to that question a little bit later. It says, if I use Duda Mobile page on how much content would be required on each page in order to get it to rank in the mobile SERPs, is it the same as a normal page, or does the mobile require less? From what I'm understanding, go ahead, Derek.
It should be the same amount of content. It's just whether or not your mobile friendly is going to be a bigger deciding factor now.
Exactly. I don't want people to get confused thinking that you're going to have to do SEO any differently. It should be mobile friendly, and you're going to rank fine just where you're at, just with the existing organic rank from your desktop. So I wouldn't overthink it too much. Next question. Did anyone get on the Duda Mobile webinar? I signed up, but it didn't send me a link. I have them leaving. Well, see. They're like asking. I've like never been on a Duda Mobile webinar, so I have no idea. There's a question for you, Derek. It says, Derek, why would my client's retail business rank in the 7-pack and not organic yet? But when you add my city to their business term, it ranks top 3 organic. So 7-pack check with my city term check. Just not my business term. Their competitors do.
If I actually saw the actual listing, I might be able to understand a little bit better. But mm-hmm. Sometimes you'll just rank just in the 7-pack because double listings are kind of tying up a lot of space, and sometimes they don't. If it's the same page that's ranking in the organic as in the 7-pack, then they'll just display one usually. So,
mm-hmm. Got it. So, Vince, if you want to send that over to Derek, just shoot him a message, and if he wants to look at it, he'll like get back to you. It's a pretty complicated question without getting some more of the information, and so don't want to think that we're trying to skip past you. The next question is, if we are powering up Web 2.0 or social property, can you discuss how many links or how much power is needed to achieve a 40-plus page authority? Well, that would depend on the links you're sending over there.
Yeah, I mean, you can be as few as one or two links a lot of times. So,
Yeah, it's just going to vary. I mean, if you're sending a lot of low quality, low DA links over, I mean, it's going to take a whole lot more. Yeah. If you send one good one over, you might be at a DA 30. So it's, once again, it just varies on the power that you're sending over to it. So
yeah, and the domain authority of that social property. So
exactly. Frank wants to discuss, it says, Aloha, can you please discuss online reputation management and the ripoff report that will be in the module on its own? Not at this time. And I want to be very clear when I like say this to everyone. And I know that people, I'm going to sound like a broken record on this. If you can't rank number one consistently everywhere with every client with local SEO terms or anything, I don't recommend you to try to get into reputation management. It's very difficult. It's a resource hog. I don't want you to think it's easy. This isn't how do I get rid of negative comments. This is how to get rid of a parasite. I know that Derek's messed with it. I've like messed with it. It's very difficult. If you haven't mastered SEO, this could literally be, and I just want to kind of explain this for everyone. Online reputation management isn't just ranking one client. It could be that you're ranking 10 clients all at once. And let me explain to you why. Because when you go into a certain page and you see a ripoff report there, you might have to move up 9 items to push that down. So you're having to do 9 times the work. And if you haven't had experience ranking things regularly, and if you're not regularly getting number ones when you do it, there could be some things that are just going to be catastrophic for you. I'd like to know that there's an OMG you're on right now that reached out to me, and I'm not going to give a lot of information about it, but she had a former NFL player that got in a little bit of trouble, and the sites that we needed to go past to get that pushed down were like, my God, were like a city newspaper, which had a domain authority of 80. There was sports sites, there was everything else. It was just DA80s across the board just to try to push down a local newspaper. Anytime you have a local newspaper, you know, like I live in Orlando, the Orlando Sentinel, I live in St. Louis and the St. Louis Post-Dispatch, and you have clients come to you and they want these pushed down or they want a ripoff report pushed down, I want you to just imagine this. It's 9 things that you might have to do, and they always come back, don't they, Derek? Generally, they always come back in time, the ripoff reports.
Yeah, you got to be careful with ripoff reports. They have a really high click-through rate too, right? Because when people search those things, they automatically gravitate to the negative stuff. Mm-hmm. And so, and then plus as an SEO, you're always, oh, look at this, and you click on it, and worse. Mm-hmm. And spam does not take those down at all, so don't even try going that way. So.
Right, right. And, if you think that you're going to GSA a ripoff report down, that's not going to work either. So what I'm like seeing, guys, is for those of you that are new and you think that this is a new, cool way to like ramp up and make $10,000, $20,000 a month, you like could be pulling your hair out. I mean, there's some online reputation management stuff that I've done that just literally just makes me want to pull my hair out. So what do you have to say, Steven, about that?
Hey, can you guys still hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Whew, I'm having computer trouble. Sorry about that.
Sorry.
Yeah, I missed part of it, guys. I apologize. I'm having internet issues, but I agree with everything I heard at the end there. It's definitely not easy. It's not easy money, like some people make it. I will tell you, and I know Cotton, you didn't give any of the specifics, but
right.
Some of the stuff that we have coming up, we're going to be able to show you how to really make an impact on some of the sites that other people just can't touch. Just frankly, I mean, like stuff that we know that we can get done, that we can teach you, where you're going to be able to make impacts on some major sites that other people just are clueless about. They wouldn't even try. So it's going to be cool. I'm excited about it. It's going to be some awesome training.
Sure. But you like missed it. What I try to tell them is if you're new and you think that this is the fad or something easy to get into, I would just stick with, Greg Morrison, SEO, client getting affiliate, whatever you want to go towards. Online reputation management. There's so many different forms of it. There's negative reviews on Yelp and Google Plus, and then there's ripoff reports. There's newspaper articles to where someone's suing someone. I've had several people come to me that are very prominent in a city and, that just said, hey, look, my wife is suing me because I was, sleeping with the younger secretary. I want this down. And it's like, whoa, it's like, are you kidding me? Like, this is the Los Angeles Times. you want me to push down the Los Angeles Times? So when you think about this, you can get over your head and the water can get pretty deep pretty quick, even for the best SEO. And it can be such a resource to do all this that it almost becomes a full-time possession. And online reputation management pricing is sometimes 5 to 6 times out of SEO. And if you're going to do online reputation management for the same price as SEO, you don't understand online reputation management.
Oh no. Yeah. Right. I would charge, at least 3 or 4 times because it's the chances of it slipping back are just, it's way, way tougher.
Exactly.
Way, way tougher. Especially like you're talking about a city newspaper.
Exactly. Oh, I just cringe when I have people contact me about that stuff. I'm like, oh my God, why?
Yeah. The review stuff is usually not too hard, like you were saying, but like that serious stuff, the good thing about reputation management, and again, I agree with you completely, Cotton, it's definitely not a starting place. It's an advanced thing. The good thing about it is, though, that, everybody needs it, right? So even if you don't have anything bad, even if there's nothing negative about you online, even having a proactive reputation management plan is something that every single business and every single person on the internet needs. So, from that perspective, it'll be great.
Definitely. Steven, I'm going to let you handle this question because I think you're going to have fun with it. It says, even though it's directed towards me, hey, Cotton, so for the most part, my sites have passed the Google mobile friendly test, but I wanted to ask, what if it's had issues when it's checked with the validator .w3.org? Will this have a factor in my ranking?
Ooh. Yeah. Yep. Thank you for letting me have that one, Cotton.
Yes.
Okay. So I think there's been some confusion. So the WC3 validator is something that has nothing to do with the mobile update. What we're talking about is Google's, what Google calls mobile friendly. And so for that, you're going to want to use the training in the other webinars. You're going to want to know what Google says. Now, the WC3C validator, if there's errors in that, they may or may not be affecting you. It depends on what they are. So forget about the mobile for just a second. Those errors, specifically could be things that you would want to address. As far as this specific mobile apocalypse, if you go to the mobile checker tool and it says that it's mobile friendly, then it doesn't matter what any other piece of software says because this is Google's update, not W3Cs or anybody else's. So third-party software and all that, it just doesn't matter at all. But again, if you're having some errors on there, you might want to run it through. I would probably ping James Upjohn or Clinton Dixon, or one of those guys. They know all that good stuff.
Sure. Moral of the story is, guys, we don't care what any third-party mobile test is. If it passes Google's mobile-friendly test, and, we've had some people say they've got some false positives or some false negatives. If you're paranoid about it and you run it a couple times and you're getting, you passed a mobile friendly or you pulled it up on your phone and you know that it is, that's all you need to know. All these other
Yeah, absolutely. And by the way, too, there were two Google Hangouts that happened this week, actual Google Hangouts. One of the things that they talked about was that 21st is when the roll is going to begin. It's going to begin in the U.S. and that it's going to take place over, quote, weeks. So it doesn't mean that necessarily on actual April 21st, April 20th at midnight, if your site isn't mobile friendly, that's going to absolutely disappear, utterly right at that second, right? But this is one of those things where it could. Mm-hmm. So, better safe than sorry.
Sure.
And I'll tell you, this is one of those things that if you're trying to think of how to get around it or how to put it off, quit it, because Google is in it you know, this is one of those things that they're behind. They're not going to change their mind. And again, the conversions and the user experience on a mobile site is just so much better than a non-mobile that there's even if there weren't this update coming up, all of your sites should have mobile versions. They just should. I mean, unless you don't care about them converting. So, and that's actually one of the things that John Mueller, who's kind of one of the top guys in the Google spam team, one of the things that he said, someone asked, you know, about it, you know, if he thought it was important to do the mobile, and he said, well, if it's important for you to get search engine traffic from Google, then yes. If you don't care about search engine traffic, then no. Don't worry about it.
Right. Yeah, this is going to be a big one. This is going to be a rolling update from what I've read also. So, you know, it's going to come out over the course of weeks. So if nothing hits right away and if your client goes, see, you lied to me, they'll be calling you shortly. So just stay in touch with them. If you know they're not mobile friendly and they've refused to move, just stay on top of it, because when their site goes, you know what I'd even do? I would even go ahead and all these people that you're close with or that you've spoken to in person, I would go ahead and put them in whatever ranking software you have. So when that day comes, when that update hits, you can obviously see, look, here's what happened and here's what's up. And I told
you. Yeah, and when clients that do opt in or clients that you have access to their analytics accounts, you know, you can track specific mobile, you know, you can tell how many hits were mobile in analytics. You don't even have to be an advanced user. You can literally click on the tab that says demographics/mobile and see how many hits they're getting from mobile. So, you know, again, if you have an existing client who already you have that access, log in and see how many hits they're getting from mobile websites, right, or from mobile devices right now. And, you know, it's probably very high if it's a highly trafficked site, and you can just say, hey, look, you're getting 300 hits a month from mobile on April. Might be getting zero hits a month from mobile. You know, why risk it?
Right, exactly. Okay, and we have an income report here for the first one right here. It says, hey, Stephen, Cotton, Derek, I sold a mobile site to a client for $800. And that's Mike. Woo-hoo! And that's Mike McCaffrey. Nice. You know what? Let's like bring him on. Let me
heck yeah.
Let me see if I can finally see if he's got a mic. We'll look down here. If a mic has a mic, he does. Let's bring him on. Let's see. Make him a panelist. Here we go. Hey, Mike, you there, buddy? Hold on. His mic hasn't shown up yet. As soon as that mic shows up, he's still trying to. He might have pulled his mic from the wall knowing he was going to come on live. No, there he is. Hey, Mike, you there, buddy? Hey, Mike, can you hear us? No, he doesn't. Mike, if you can, you know, if you just talk and just interrupt us if you know you're able to get your mic working, we would love to be able to find out how you got that $800 one. You know what, guys? We always want to try to support everyone that gives an income report. Let's just give a hashtag. You know, let's say you know, that might be Mike right there.
He's just grabbing his mic. That's what he says.
Oh, yeah, great. Yeah, he's going to go get one. But, guys, let's show Mike, hey, great job on that $800. Let's do a hashtag, I don't know, way to go, Mike. Mike Long's going to think this is about him. let's throw their way to go, Mike. You sold an $800 site. And as soon as he gets a mic, we're going to find out how he did it. He might have some different ways that we're doing it. Always love hearing how anyone's kind of capitalized on something to go. So we're going to start with our first hashtag, way to go, Mike. And as soon as he gets the mic, we will definitely come back to him. So let's go to the next question. It says, someone says that I was told it sounded fishy. My phone skills need work. Guys, you need to always, you know, if someone can just search mobile update April 21st, it's going to come up all over the internet. If no one believes you, just always remember that. It says no replies yet, but every day I send out 50 emails. It says, here we go. Can we go over the fix again? Says, hey, Cotton, this one about social citations, though, hope it is okay to ask here. If I'm using a PMD, because EMD is not available for my money site, for the Facebook page and Twitter page, should I use the exact match as part of the URL to help with my ranking or maintain a partial match keyword that is similar to the money site? Thanks. Trying to wrap my head around that question.
Derek, do you want to? I get what he's saying. I think what he's saying is on his social property, like if it's bobsroofing.com on his social property, should he still put Bob's Roofing or should he put Dallas Roofing if he's actually Dallas Roofing?
Yeah, we'll let Derek answer. I think go ahead,
Derek.
So maybe dig in. Well, anytime you can get any keyword in the subdomain or the Facebook page, you're going to be a little bit ahead of the competition. So
what he's Derek, what he's basically saying is now I just reread it. He has an EMD, but the EMD isn't available for Facebook. So what should he do? Is a PMD?
Yeah, next question.
Right. So So it says here, hope it is okay to ask. It says I'm using a PMD because the EMD is not available for the money site. So Facebook and Twitter, and also for the Facebook Twitter, should I use the exact match as part of the URL to help with the ranking or maintain partial match? So what he's saying is if the exact match is available on Facebook, should he go with the exact match on Facebook or should he still go with the partial match, which matches his site?
I'd do the exact match personally, but the partial match will just be you're a little extra safe probably, so it's and it'll possibly be a little bit more branded towards your site, so sometimes I would go with that.
The advantage to using the exact match is if you wanted to rank those pages. If you're trying to actually rank your Facebook and your Twitter page, then I would use the EMD version. If you're not trying to rank those pages and they're just supporting pages, for your legitimate Web 2.0s for your main domain, I would use the brand or the PMD. But again, like Derek said, you are going to get an advantage when you do that, if you use the exact match. So, I would weigh your options there. Personally, I would do the branded is what I would do.
The brand is going to be good for if you ever have to do reputation management on yourself too. So,
yeah, good point.
Okay, I'm looking at questions here. There's a lot of. How does forwarding a mobile site on a different domain impact on SEO? Anyone of you guys want to answer that?
Yeah, you want me to, Derek, or you want? Well, I think. Hold on one second. I think what they're asking about is. The fact that Duda Mobile is actually, it's a third-party site, right? Your mobile site is actually hosted on another site. It's not hosted on your site. And so let me give you a couple of short reasons why. Number one, Duda Mobile has a content delivery network. And so that means that your mobile site is going to be served up from a local server to where you are. So, if your money site is hosted on a local server, then you're in your mobile's on your money site's hosting, then that's fine. But a lot of people, it's not. They may be hosting, somewhere on GoDaddy, their money site, and might not be anywhere close to where their clients are. So, advantage number one would be that your mobile site is delivered via a content delivery network. That's one thing. Number two, the SEO options in Duda Mobile are built in, and they're easy to navigate. So, you don't have to have any kind of skill in coding or anything like that to be able to do your updates. And as far as a redirect, that's what Google Bot expects. When it goes to your page, it's going to read the information in your header. And if it finds, mobile version and it's on a mobile device, it's going to redirect it. It's expecting to redirect. So
it's also not it's from a juice point of view, it's not losing the juice from your site either.
Oh,
it's,
no.
User agent redirect, so it's not
absolutely. Absolutely. So, I don't know if that. I hope that answered the question, but let me just say it this way: hosting using a mobile site from a third-party company like Duda Mobile has zero negative impacts for your SEO for your mobile pages. If I could say that.
Okay, got it. We're going to skip down to some questions while you guys were answering it. I didn't hear what you said. I'm looking for other questions. It says, "Is this correct?" And this is from Karen. Duda Mobile sites are hosted independently from a main website and therefore only show up in mobile SERP results question mark? If so, then does the mobile site need its own SEO in order to rank?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And those options are in due to mobile. If you look on the webinar, I went through really briefly, there's like an SEO tab, actually, where you can put in, you know, your standard, you know, quote on page, you know, stuff for that. And so, yeah.
Okay.
It's ready.
Great. It says, I use Jetpack to mobilize a WordPress site with a thesis theme. I made this site half size on my iPhone. Any idea why this? Guys, that's Laura. Unfortunately, I would refer that over to Mike Hayden or Clinton Dixon.
Seems like a
website thing. And unfortunately, I don't do web design. So
yeah, I'd refer that too.
Right. Let's see here. People want to know if there's still a discount for due to mobile. I have no idea. You'd have to contact them.
Yeah. There, you know what? It ended on the 23rd, but guess what? It officially ended on the 23rd, which is 2 days ago. But I know people that called today and talked to a rep and got the discount today. So if you're on the fence about it, jump off the fence and buy it while it's half off.
Okay. Here's a question that Dale has. It says, when I look on my cell phone, many times businesses will show up with a call button, but no website. Is this a button Google places on their searches, but only shows up randomly? I've only seen this myself. I mean, I'll like answer this. I think I know what he's talking about. I've only seen
sure.
it with AdWords Express. That you're able to pay to have a call button beside your listing on a mobile phone, and you just pay for everyone that clicks that and takes the phone calls over. So it's almost like Google is doing a pay-per-lead. It's different than AdWords. You have to do it through, if I'm not mistaken, Google Plus is you access it through there. It's AdWords Express, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, AdWords Express.
Does that make sense, guys?
Yeah, it makes perfect sense.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that's where you're seeing that at. So if you have customers that want that on there, go through AdWords Express. That's what that is. If you haven't heard AdWords Express, it's a little bit different than AdWords. I'll just let you play around with that. That's a whole other webinar, actually, just going over that alone. Let's see here. Google review question. I've noticed that when a customer goes to leave a review on a desktop or laptop, they have no problems. However, if they go on a mobile device, there is no option to leave a review. Is that a setting on my Google Plus biz page to activate that? Steven?
That's a brand new feature. Brand new, like a month maybe, maybe a little bit longer, that where they allowed you to actually do that. I don't know if it's a button or if it's supposed to be automatic. I'm sorry. Whoever asked that, if they want to, Jeff, if you want to PM me, you know, tomorrow or something, I'll get an answer for you. But I know that this has only been available a very short time. I do know, though, now that you brought it up, another thing I wanted to mention, you know, there's a Google My Business app, guys, okay, for iPhones and for, you know, Androids. There's an actual Google My Business app. And when you use the Google My Business app from your smartphone, then you can leave reviews and manage reviews and stuff directly through there. So that's something really good, you know, for you to do for your own or even to teach your you know, your clients to do. They can respond to their, you know, reviews and stuff like that directly through the app. So it's quick and easy. Like, they can even set to have a notification. Whenever someone leaves a review, they'll get a notification in the Google My Business app, and then they know they've got something, you know, they can go look at it or respond to it or whatever.
Great. The next question is by WN. It says, a client is on the 7-pack for an old address that has 2 bad reviews associated with it. Can I change the address on this?
You know what I mean?
Go ahead.
I can take that one.
Sure.
You want to be careful. I mean, you know, there's a couple of different ways you can handle this. The easiest way, so it's got two bad reviews, so more than likely you'd want to just kill that list with a new one. Unless, you know, that listing just has a lot of other really good qualities and it's really old, and then you would simply, you know, you would log into Google My Business and edit the address and then re-verify, typically. The reviews will not follow you if you create a new one, unless they're on third-party sites, typically, although they can. And that's one of those, this is one of those gray areas that really nobody can answer for you what's going to happen for sure. So, you know, if you've got, if the reviews are really hurting you, you might want to, you know, start new. The other option, of course, is to just go ahead and, you know, get some good reviews. So number one, you've got to make sure the address, you have a Google My Business with the correct address. It's crucial. And then as far as addressing the reviews, you know, it's easier just to, you know, smush those with good reviews.
Got it. Next question is directed towards Derek. It says, Derek, what is the name of the click-to-call plugin you are using?
Good question. Something like click-to-call me, I think. Maybe. You just search around in the WordPress directory. There's usually click-to-call or tap-to-call. There's a few different ones. I've tried several, but all it really is doing is hyperlinking a phone number. If you just Google, well, maybe I can send the link. I'll send the link in here. There's just, it's just a little short link code so that when anyone clicks on a button, that it prompts the phone to use a phone number.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll just drop that in here if I find the actual code. But I put those on all my responsive websites.
Great. Pat wants to know, is this webinar a quick run through on Due to Mobile? No, it isn't. It's going to be totally different here in a second. We're just going through and answering questions. It says, if someone does not have a mobile-friendly site by the 21st, will it also negatively affect their results on a PC?
Well, technically, Derek, did you want to go ahead?
Well, we don't know yet, but it could be because, I mean, with almost 60% of local traffic, or at least, is mobile, it might start dragging down your desktop rankings too. So
that's what I was gonna say. You know, it absolutely, you know, is not going to directly affect it. You know, but when you lose all that traffic, and you lose all those click throughs and stuff, you know, I can pretty much promise you it's going to affect. Pretty much guarantee it's going to affect it.
Okay, great. It says here, I have a brain buster mystery for Stephen Floyd if he wants to take a look at it. It says, a competitor's site ranks number one organic, but two spots in the map pack. But one map pack spot is a different URL. How do they do that?
They have crazy. To be different URLs.
That's crazy talk right there.
That's not possible.
That's not possible. You know what? Listen, if you mean by URL, you mean the same domain, just a different URL, or do they mean a different, like the same company with a different domain? I'm assuming they mean one site with multiple URLs. And so
they have multiple verified addresses in the same city.
So yeah. Like. Yeah. So, Derek, go ahead, because that's basically what they're doing, right? So.
Yeah, so if you have, you know, you're just down the street from one listing, or like, a lot of gas stations and like domos and all that kind of stuff that would have locations all over the city, right? So they're going to show up in the same map pack usually. So if they were optimized properly, of course, but you could have, you could probably dominate the whole 7-pack. I think with Jimmy Kelly had that one for model show homes in Utah, if you want to search that one, maybe.
Yeah, I mean, this is going to be, whenever you see multiple results in a 7-pack, one thing that you can almost heard of is that it's a weak pack, okay? So, you know, if there's strong, legitimate listings, you know.
Or Jimmy Kelly did it.
Or Jimmy did it. That's a good point. Or Jimmy did it, yeah. But unless you're Jimmy, as normal humans, you know, you're not gonna get multiple spots in the pack in any kind of pack that has any value. So it's a neat trick. It looks cool to the client, you know. But it's just, you know, if there's any value to it, someone's going to be fighting for it. So.
Mm-hmm. Great.
I think there's model homes in Utah. That's the example that Jimmy used to have.
Mm-hmm.
Try that con maybe if you can.
Hold on.
It doesn't show up for me properly in Canada. Model homes in Utah. I think they used to have.
Hold on. No, they don't have anything. They don't have a.
There's no. Try model homes, Utah.
I did. Oh.
No, without the inn.
Oh, hold on. Let's see.
It's one of the 7-pack.
Nope. They could have removed it. I mean, I'm going to be honest with you. I just noticed in a lot of SEO cities that they have added 7-packs and removed some. St. Louis added them back over the last couple of days. So,
well, Ivory Homes is maybe it's Salt Lake, Utah. That's what it is.
Model Home Salt Lake.
Yeah.
It's like plan.
This is unscripted, people.
That's right, obviously. No. The good news is we just know that it can be done.
I'll find it.
Yeah, we like know that it can be done. So next question.
Well, he also lost it.
Sure. Next question is for those of you that are beginners, and it says, how many hosting accounts and which ones ought we to begin with? And that's always an interesting question. And Steven and Derek might have different answers. If I was first starting right now, you know, it's really okay for your first 4 or 5 sites to, you know, set up your first site on GoDaddy hosting and then one on HostGator to make it real easy. And, you know, just kind of spread them around a little bit until you can get to, you know, where you need to get with something where you have separate IPs, as long as it's all mixed in together. So for those of you that are just starting out, it's okay to do onesies here and there to bounce around a little bit because it's not connected. But after you get past your onesies, you're going to have to think of a better strategy. So, Steven, you want to elaborate on that?
Yeah. So he's talking about – is he talking about for PBNs, I'm guessing?
Yes. Yeah, obviously. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So when you're doing that, what Cotton said or, you know, Derek showed a really cool, you know, thing a couple – months ago about basically how to get free hosting. And so, you know, that's a really good option for you as well, you know, using Web 2.0s. And then there's actually even straight up real quote-unquote free hosting, like just Google free hosting. And obviously, you know, they're not super great, but, you know, you can get them for free. And then, you know, when you got 50 cents, you know, you can buy the quote upgrade and it's, you know, $4 for the year or whatever. So, you know, when you're starting off, you know, it's okay, you know, to do that kind of stuff.
Sure. And then there's other places you can go to, like Biz Builder Hosting, you know, that Todd has, you know, and then some other places also. And that's all in the training in OMG. So I believe Greg goes through that pretty thoroughly, you know. So if you're brand new, go over all of Greg Morrison's material. And,
amen.
Yeah. And you'll be 100% set. That's how I learned. So
sure. And hey, by the way, guys, if you're advanced, go over all of Greg Morrison's training.
Yeah. Exactly.
As well.
Exactly. Let's see here. We're now just getting caught up with our online reputation rant. So that was a long time ago. let's see. Keep clicking through here trying to find what's a ripoff report. Well, just search ripoff report and you'll find out. It says, here's the next question. I was hired to get a consumer in the 7-pack. After having them fill out a form as to what their Google My Business and NAP was and them stating they were verified, only to find out the information was completely incorrect. It took 2 months to get them verified because they kept making new Google My Business pages. All 100 citations we did were not done from their old unverified page, which is now the verified page. Oh my God, this still keeps going. PMJ, do me a favor, buddy. Whenever you sign onto the webinars, use your real name so we know who you are and like OMG. So this is from PMJ. So why don't you message one of us and like Facebook tomorrow and then we'll answer it for you. So when you log in, use your real name so we know who you are. We don't know who PMJ is. For all we know, you might have stole the link from somewhere and yeah. like on here. So it's a super long question.
People off too.
Yeah, super long question. So just hit us up and let us know you're an OMG. Just send me a message and I'll be happy to help you fix that tomorrow. It says the next question is from Andrew. It says, I have three clients' websites using the Enfold theme to pass the Google mobile test. One fails. Wondering what's a good plan to fix this?
Watch the last two webinars.
Exactly. What he's like trying to say is he's got one theme, two are passing it, one isn't. I have no idea. But, I mean, I like wish I could tell you that I was a web designer that knows what all this stuff does. I know about SEO and I know how to get clients. So I know that sounds pretty one-dimensional, but that's exactly what the facts are. So
yeah, and I can guarantee if you go ahead and just do the Duda Mobile plan, mm-hmm. then it doesn't matter what your theme is.
Exactly.
So it fixes this, Andrew, is, you know.
Right. Let me see here. I was like reading. It was a very long one. It says, how would you mobilize an affiliate site? Just the same as you would any other site. Don't overthink it.
Absolutely.
It says, is the best objective a single site that is mobile or a separate mobile site?
Honestly, it makes zero difference. If you want to have an M.dot version of your site and you know what you're doing, then there's nothing wrong with that. You know, again, I would refer to what I said, you know, back before. You know, if your site is, you know, not super fast or whatever, then, you know, having it hosted on something, you know, like Duda that has a CDN, a content delivery network, to speed things up is going to help quite a bit. Actually, at that point, Cotton, if you don't mind, guys, give me a three if you have no idea what I mean when I say content delivery network. Like, you're completely have no idea. And I can't see the answers right now, I don't think. Anybody?
Yeah, there's threes rolling in.
Okay. So let me just take like 30 seconds to explain this. I promise it'll be easy. So, you know, your website has bunches of, say the homepage, it has a lot of content on it, okay? Say it has lots of images or it has lots of videos, okay? And so if your website is somewhere in Los Angeles and someone from, you know, New York goes to visit it, then that's a long distance. And when they get there, the web server in where you're at has to send that information through the internet, all of it back to all the way across the country, right, to get there. So what a content delivery network does, it grabs your content, the most of your content, especially the videos, the images, and all the stuff that's really data, takes up a lot of data, and it keeps it on its machines, but not in one place. It keeps it on machines all over the place. So if your site was in Dallas and someone in New York looked for it, when they clicked on the link, it would actually be coming from a server in New York, not from Dallas. So this not only makes your website, you know, much more fast and responsive, right? When they click on the SERP and they get to your site, it pulls up immediately, right? But you know, it also is basically, it's just going to enhance the overall experience. So, you know, using a content delivery network, if you serve results, especially, you know, nationally, it, you know, can be very important for you. It can be very beneficial. And there's a free comes with WordPress if you want to, you know, use it, called Photon. And then there is Cloudflare. There's several. So anyway, that was longer than 30 seconds. But basically, a content delivery network is where someone else shares your content for you in a location that's closer to the person searching for it. So it's faster. Mm-hmm. Hope that makes sense. Guys, give me a four if that makes sense now. Or five if you're still have no idea. You get many fives, Derek?
4.5.
4.5, okay.
Right. I'm not looking because I'm trying to stay on the next question. So I was gonna let you guys monitor that. If you want to,
if it's not clear, guys, for you, just shoot it in the Facebook group, in OMG. Just shoot it in the Facebook group, and I'm sure we can get you sorted out. Promise.
Great. All right, guys. Next question is gonna be an interesting one, and it says, I came across a web design company, and 100% of all the sites made for their clients fail the mobile test. Was trying to come up with a creative offer and solution that would work with everyone. Well, Carl, I mean, Andrew, my friend, the thing that I'm pulling out of your question is that I was going to say, well, do you have access to all their clients to find out if they don't pass the mobile test? And obviously you do, because you just said that all of them failed the mobile friendly test. My question to you is this. Why do you want to involve that other web design company?
Amen.
Why do you even want to reach out to them? It sounds like that you're going to be working with people that have no clue what they're doing, or they don't care about taking care of their clients who would have been on this. This is what I would do. What I would do is there, Armando did a similar video series. It's somewhere in OMG, and it's in the members area somewhere, called the Ugly Duckling Method. And what you basically do is if you've got access to all these clients, I'm going to show you here in a little bit how you can pitch every one of this person's clients, if you have access to them, all at once. Give me a two. If you yourself would like to pitch, I'm not talking about just, you know, send a text message or do that. If you would like to have the opportunity to pitch each and every one of these people that this web design company has, if you have access to it.
Heck yeah.
Exactly. I didn't even look, and I already know that this is the number. I don't even remember what number I said. But we're going to show you here in a moment why my emails are so effective and how I'm able to pull these people over to me very, very, very quickly. And we're going to answer a few more questions, and we're going to get to that. But Andrew, my advice to you is don't involve these other people. I would go after these people, and I would be respectful about it, and I would just say, look, I like notice that you're all former clients, or so-and-so did web design work with you, and I notice that every single one of their clients is not mobile friendly. And all you have to do is just, you know, have a screenshot of Google Mobile's friendly test and just send it over to them, or just call them up and show them proof of it and just start digging away. And I'm going to even show you a better way about how to reach them. So we're going to get to that in a moment. So next question is, would you recommend using anything else other than Due to Mobile, meaning building mobile on your own domain, which is ultimately better and easier for long-term action?
I think we kind of answered that a minute ago, but I would question the it's a question, which is ultimately better and easier.
Right.
Well, the way that the pricing goes, and Due to Mobile is not magic. They're just like the Coca-Cola, you know, of this industry, and that's why I work with them, and that's why I suggest them to you. And I'm not like an affiliate or anything. I don't get paid to send people to them. I should. It'd be awesome. But making the mobile websites yourself and keeping them up to date yourself, it means that you're going to have to be constantly making changes and, you know, FTPing and HTML, and, you know, every time they want some new feature, like some new button or something, you're going to have to come up with that. And if you use a partner like Due to Mobile, any option that your client's going to want, they're going to have. And also, they're going to market it through you to the end user. So, you know, I don't know what the thing is, but, you know, right now, you know, it's click to call buttons, right? Or it's a map, you know, click for directions. But whatever that next hot thing is, you can bet that Due to Mobile is going to have it, and it's going to be a little button that you're going to drag across and drop onto their mobile website instead of you having to try to figure out how to code it or find some other, you know, solution. So, you know, my hearty recommendation is that unless you're a web designer and that's your primary occupation, I would use a partner like Due to Mobile. Just easy, 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 easy money.
Mm-hmm. Great. Next question. One of my sites is HTML, and I no longer have access to who made it. Do I need to link everything to that site if I want to mobilize it? Like, will I need to put a redirect code on it or not? If not, how will Google know they are linked and not penalize the main site thing?
Yeah, Carol, you're going to – one of the things that you're – so most of you are using WordPress probably, and with WordPress, with Due to Mobile, they have a plugin. So actually install any code by hand. There's two steps to using Due to Mobile if you're using WordPress. One is you create an A record in your hosting account, which can be done in 10 seconds, and They have training that shows you how to do it, or a salesperson will literally walk you through it. It's super easy. But the other thing you need to do, if you have the plugin, is just install the plugin, right? But if it's an HTML site, you can't use the plugin. You're going to have the redirect code installed on the site. When Googlebot gets to your website, it has to read the code that says, you know, if mobile, then, you know, go here. So if you don't have access to the site more, that's going to be challenging. I'm not – Derek, do you know any way to do that?
If they don't have access to the site, it's well, if you're using just the A record, you can you're going to be hosting a mobile site wherever you want to. So,
but I mean, is there any way for the? But is there any way to get around the redirect issue, though? I'm just saying, like, if how will their site know that it's coming from a mobile device?
That's a good question.
This may be like a Jimmy or something. He may know some cool way to do that without having access to it. I don't.
There might be a mobile redirect for the A record. I'm not sure. Let me check.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know anything about that. When my people come to me with these sort of questions, I tell them to go to their web designer. When they figure it out, let me know. I just do SEO, and I keep my life real simple, and that's how I'm able to ramp up very quickly. So, guys, I'm just going to go off on your rant a little bit. When you get involved in, like, when you have clients that, like, come to you, and I'm not saying that there's anything wrong with asking that question, but when you have clients that come to you with these crazy questions, your first instinct is to immediately serve them. That's not mine. I have a certain task that I do. It's like you go to a heart surgeon and you tell him, I want you to work on my brain. He's going to tell you, not happening. I do hearts. But you don't understand. I want you. And or there's no heart surgeon that's so desperate that he's going to be doing that. So guys, if you truly don't know something, or if you don't want to be involved in something, just speak up and say it. Because I get phone calls all the time going, yeah, I need this site migration over here and this and this. And I'm like, you know what? I totally understand what you're trying to explain to me to do, but unfortunately, my job is strictly SEO. Now that's how I choose to do my business. If you want to make money and if you want to ramp up quickly, you getting involved in other of these side projects that are just a couple, you know, a thousand here, a couple hundred there, that's one time shot, you're not going to be able to ramp up very quickly to make money. I only do things that are reoccurring. So for me to get involved in this sort of stuff, nickel and dime here, there, or, you know, helping someone, and you go, well, Cotton, isn't that a form of SEO splitting? No, it's me being something that I'm not. I'm not a web designer. And I don't know how to move stuff over from server to server, nor do I want to know. I'm good at SEO, and I'm good at getting clients. So that's what I'm going to stick with. I don't care how big of a client is, even if it's $10,000, $15,000 a month. If he's asking me, hey, look, I need you to totally redesign my website, it's not happening. I'm just going to say, look, I can refer you over to someone, and when it gets done, let me know. But in the meantime, I can still be doing SEO on your site. They can be done simultaneously. Hey, well, what about this? Like, hey, you know, I can refer you over to someone. So guys, don't be scared to stay on your ground. Now, if you want to be that handyman or that repairman that's kind of great at nothing, but kind of good or okay at everything, and if that's what you love doing, then that's great. But if you think you're going to ramp up to a $50,000 agency and SEO very, very, very quickly by trying to be a one-man show and trying to handle everything, I really think that that's slowing you down. So I want to say that and just kind of drill this in people's heads with mindsets. So get good at one thing, and it's okay. Guys, you don't have to make dinner or, you know, wash the client's car or just anything like this. It's just a simple, you know, we just don't do that. You don't go to Taco Bell and ask them for a Big Mac. It's crazy. So
some people do.
Exactly. Right. Right. You don't chew out the Porsche dealer for not having a Harley Davidson. It's just different things. People do different stuff, and it's okay to say.
Hey, Cotton, can I say something real quick?
Sure.
I was looking at the question again that Carol Stone asked.
Right.
And I think that I think I may have misunderstood part of it. I think she's saying that she doesn't have access to the person who coded the site, not that she doesn't have access to the site. So that, I think, is what she's asking. So, Carol, if that's what you're actually asking, then mobile will actually give you the HTML code that you need to add to your site, and they will actually even talk you through doing it. So if that's what you were saying, that you can log into the site, you just don't know how to do it, they will absolutely help you with that. Just call in, call their support line, and they will walk you, stay on the phone with you for 30 minutes if they have to.
Right. Great. The newest question that just came in, it says, and then we're going to get on to the lesson. It like says, what do you recommend for someone great at SEO but not landing clients? Well, guys, I recommend you to find someone. It depends on if you want to get great at getting clients. Do you want to be that person? If you want to be that person, then study client getting and get good at it. If it's something that you just is like, I despise web design. I mean, if that's your thing, I don't have anything against it. But to me, for me to go out and just score $2,500 or $5,000 once, I don't need money that bad. Now, if you do, I encourage you to go out. And if you know how to build a website, don't turn money down if you need money coming in. But with my business model and ramping up quickly, for me to sit and waste all day and make $2,500, I could have already closed a client at $2,500. It's reoccurring. It's going to make me $25,000 over the course of the year or down the road. So my whole thing is that, you know, Derek, I'm going to ask you and I'm going to kind of put you on the spot. Do you like dealing with clients?
No, not unless I have to.
Right, right. And
when it comes to like technical stuff, then I have to, but...
Right.
Yeah, I have someone else do it.
Don't you find it easier when like someone goes out and gets the clients for you and just pays you a premium for your SEO?
Yeah, because pretty much I'd be just like, oh, okay, see you later, then bye.
Right, right. Hey, guys, and this is true. Jimmy hates clients.
And yeah, he doesn't even answer the phone.
No, Jimmy doesn't even answer the phone on his SEO agency. So what I'm saying is, guys, don't think you're abnormal. Or don't think you're crazy because you don't want to do something. This is exactly why you came to OMG. It's to be happy and to do what you want to do. I don't want you to think you got to get in a rat race and do things that you just don't want to do. You have to just set your course of action up the way you want to do it. I don't want to do web design. I don't want to do PPC. I don't want to do nothing. I just want to do SEO. And that's what I tell people. So, you know, Derek has found a lot of ways to where – and my goal between now and Christmas, and I've got the plan in order that I'm going to ramp up to 1 million a month. And for me to ramp up to 1 million a month, I'm going to have to bring on some people. I'm not going to be able to do it alone. One of the things is I would just call Derek and say, Derek, I'm going to give you just thousands and thousands of dollars of all these clients to do my SEO. And Derek would go, thank you. I don't want to go out and get clients. Derek enjoys doing SEO. And I enjoy going out and getting clients. I enjoy SEO, but I enjoy them equal. So someone like Derek's going to be happy, you know, but Derek's just not going to do SEO for anyone. He has to know there's volume coming in and other stuff. And you can find someone that's really good at getting clients and team up with them. That's why we're in a community. That's why we're OMG. So find someone that's got a quality that, and if you want to get good at getting clients, go out and learn how to do that. And continue to fight through it and do it. But if you don't, find someone that's great at sales but sucks at SEO and, you know, form a partnership together. And are you going to be able to ramp up quickly? No, but it's better than you trying to be something that you're not. So, you know, I just happen to be good at you know, speaking and SEO and client getting. I don't know anything about web design. Don't want to know anything about web design. In my head, I start to get a headache when someone starts talking about it. Just like, whatever. I have a guy that, if you go to cottongrammar.com with the about section, Mark, who's in OMG, anytime I have something go wrong with my website, I just call Mark up, and I think he's on right now, and Mark fixes it, and boom. And Mark loves, and he understands web design. It's like he's amazing at it. So it's easier for me just to let him do it than for me to learn a whole other profession when SEO is hard enough to stay on top of it and to be the best at it alone. So hopefully that helps. And I know that.
Hey, Connor.
Yeah.
Can I make a suggestion? And I don't know if it's a good one or not.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you started the mentor thread.
Yeah.
And I think that was awesome. It's one of those things where you see that and I'm just like, what? Why weren't we doing like this forever? You know, when you see it. And so I wonder, and maybe, you know, I don't know if it's a good idea or not, but I'm noticing the comments on here. Mm-hmm. Maybe we could start a same kind of a thread where I'm the salesman or I'm the SEO.
Sure.
And just hashtag it. You know, hashtag I'm the salesman or hashtag I'm the SEO. Yeah. And you guys can, because listen, what Cotton says, you know, one of the biggest reasons why people fail in business is because, you know, the people are good at something. So let's say, you know, you're a good locksmith, right? And you're like, hey, I'm the best locksmith. You know, why work for this guy? You know, I should just go, you know, open my own business. But the thing is, he doesn't know how to sell locksmithing. He doesn't know how to run a business. He just knows how to do locksmiths, right? He just knows how to get into locks. So these guys a lot of times go out of business. So if you're the technician, right, like Derek is a technician. If you're the technician, then find someone who's the salesman, you know, and vice versa. If you're the salesman, you know, and I'll tell you this, you know, you guys, I don't know if you, some of you know, some of you don't, you know, I have a degree in psychology and I'm in a PhD program for it. I'll tell you this, what's been proven over and over again, guys, if you're the salesperson, really, and you're trying to be the SEO, you're going to be freaking miserable. And the reverse goes true, too. If you're a technician, if you're the SEO and you're trying to make yourself into a salesman, you're not only going to be miserable, but you're going to be crappy at it and you're going to be broke. So you know, if you know that about yourself, if you can look yourself in the mirror and say, you know, I'm just not a salesman at this point, you know, but I'm really good at ranking, find someone who's good at sales and vice versa. So flip it around. And then that way, you know, you have a partner as well.
Right. I want to address something just to clear up something. Tracy wrote a question. Says, hey, Cotton, how do you do SEO without accessing titles links? I don't want you guys to think that I don't know how to build a website. I know how to build a website, and I'm amazing at on-page SEO. But to me, that's not web design. You know, logging onto a WordPress site, putting on a plugin, and putting in keywords, making sure the titles are in order, and making sure that the site's SEO optimized is not web design. To me, that's SEO. So what I'm like talking about is I have no desire to do site mergers, remove this site from this server to this server and make sure nothing happens, or you know, build this big giant e-commerce site, or hey, I want to refresh my website and do my SEO. I just don't want to do that. I want them to go out, find a web designer, get the refresh done, then come back to me. But yes, I know how to build a website, and I know enough about HTML to be dangerous, but that doesn't mean that I love doing it. So that's why there's some people here. I guarantee you that Mark, who's on right now, could literally go circles around me. He could finish something in 2 minutes. Would probably take me an hour just to get and figure it out. So it doesn't mean I can't figure it out. It's just my time's better spent making money than it is to do that. So that's why. So hope that kind of explains it. So yes, I do know how to build a website, and I do take care of titles and on-page SEO and all that other stuff. So there you go. So with that, we are going to, I believe we've been doing questions and answers now for about an hour. Guys, let me ask questions. Do you like that idea that Stephen had to start a thread with, hey, I'm the sales, I'm the SEO, I'm the web designer. Give me a number 5 if you think that's a fantastic idea. Great. Yeah, we're getting a lot of 5s here. You know what? I just say that why don't we just do it right now inside the thread, just in case we don't get a chance to do it. Guys, I want you to type in your skill in the Facebook group right now, what you're great at. Just hashtag sales, hashtag SEO, or just do all three if you're great at all three. Maybe you can, you know, do all three. Just do hashtag sales, hashtag SEO, hashtag web design. And let everyone know if you're looking for a partner, if you're wanting to do it, just add it in the group right now. So put it right in there and we can wait a couple minutes to see, and we can get the thread going. And then what we can do is just move forward from there. So let me see if we're getting any activity.
And we're talking thread in Facebook, guys, not in GoToWebinar.
Yeah. Well, there's certain people, Director's Cut Only doesn't have access to.
Oh yeah. Sorry. My bad.
Yeah. The Facebook group. So, yeah. So it looks like there's people thought it was a good idea, but not a lot of people participate. At least yet. And we're not on delay, so we will see. But Greg, right. So guys, come on, fill this up. I'd like to know. Let everyone know what you got, and then you can meet up with everyone later. Man, this is like an SEO dating service we got going on right now. Hi, Vic Matthews. I want you to meet, like we're looking at here. Fran says, I hate sales. So, Fran, I want you to meet Brandon. Welcome. Couple number one.
So, right. I feel like SEO speed dating for this
one. Yeah. That's what we're doing right now. This is SEO speed dating.
There is a lot more sales than I thought there was going to be. This
exactly.
Is, this is great.
Wow. This is cool. Look at that.
This is going to be all SEO.
Guys, and I'm going to be honest with you, this can help you ramp up. You know, if you've got someone just out doing sales and they're going to depend on you to do the SEO, and you know, you split the cash, you can ramp up pretty freaking quick. So what we want to do is we want to get income reports. I mean, there are several people. Look at Derek. He even put SEO mania, man. And George O'Brien says it. George O'Brien says, screw all you. I'm just doing mobile. He goes, that's all I'm doing. He says, I'm just doing mobile. So we have got our own OMG dating service going on, and I kind of like it. So give me a number 9 if you like this OMG SEO dating service going on. Exactly. A lot of 9s here. Hold on. It says, I'm a mini cotton. Same mentality when I saw you at the convention. I said that to me. I went on date. Yeah. Greg's, yeah.
She did mini cottons and mini Derek's.
Yeah. I need to tell Mike, Mike's a great matchmaker, man. You know, Mike was on here. I'd love to get him on here to say that, you know, we're going to start the SEO dating service on here. So guys, listen, find someone and reach out to them. Now, listen. Here's what I've got to say about that mentor thread. For those of you that need a mentor, this is going to blow you guys away. And now, look, I want you to wait before you put in the number. But what if I told you, I want you to put a number 9, I already did 9, so let's do a 2. I want you to put a number 2 in the chat box if it would blow you away that only one person asked me to mentor them. Me too, if that blows you away. Guys, out of all of OMG, give me a 5 if that didn't surprise you at all. I mean, so that's what, some white people said it's surprising. To me, I was like, wow. Guys, listen, be aggressive. Be aggressive. If you need a mentor, just say, hey, I want you to be my mentor. What do I need to do to take this to happen? Because I can tell you this. If someone politely asks me, they have to sell themselves before I'm going to mentor them. I mean, I'm going to be honest with you. Angela, God bless her heart, you know, back when she first started, Angela Langlotz was relentless on me. She would just machine gun me with messages and not leave me alone. I just said, damn it, I guess I'm just going to have to take you under my wing. So, you know, it's either I didn't know what else to do. So that's what it is. So guys, when you have someone that you want to be your mentor, be aggressive and go out and say something to them. Just don't sit back and go, damn it, OMG. I put mentor in there and no one loves me. Come on, guys. I mean, find someone that you've seen in the thread and reach out to them. I want you to get success and I want them to pass down the information that they've had. So, hey, look, we got – you know what? Uh-oh.
The 2.
We're going to go look for him because I want to see what Mike –
he's not even on the webinar, I don't think.
He's not?
Oh, I know. He doesn't know what we're talking about.
He's not. Damn it. I was going to Yeah.
Hey, Cotton.
Yes.
I mean, I don't know if we have time on this webinar, but sure. You know, when you were talking about that, those of you probably don't know it, there was a kind of a charity giveaway deal in a group, and Cotton very generously donated – his time to do some coaching to someone who really needed it. I don't know if you wanted to comment on that because, you know.
Oh, you know what? Mike is on right now. Hey, Mike, what's up, buddy? Come on, Mike. Unmute yourself. There you are. Mike, I think that this OMG SEO dating service, I think that you should get behind this.
Yeah. Does this have anything to do with Drunk SEO? That was a big theme from OMG Live Nashville was Drunk SEO. We have Drunk SEO and an SEO dating service also. Who all is on there? I heard Stephen Floyd. Let me get a brand. Obviously, I know Cotton's there. Who else is? Oh, Derek.
Derek? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I wanted to make sure I knew who I was dealing with.
What do you think about the idea of everyone posting what they're great at and mixing up with their match? Someone that's great at SEO and...
Let's get some hashtags going. Like, what's going on here?
Yeah.
Get some mobile. I was at dinner. I see hashtag mobile, hashtag WordPress.
Right.
Their skills.
Yeah, skills. They're like hashtagging their skills so they can meet up with another OMG-er to work together.
Yeah, you know, one of the things, Cotton and I were talking about this, but one of the fundamental ideas, one of the real core principles of OMG goes back, obviously David Mills designed OMG, and then he recruited, you know, me and Greg. You know, he envisioned this idea of OMG around working with me and Greg, and then obviously wonderfully we've expanded it to Fletch and then Cotton and Joe and Jimmy and Russell and Sue and now Liz and so forth. But anyways, the core idea of it, which was literally amazing, David were top magic players in the world, and David really understood about learning. He really was always fascinated about it. And we would talk about it. I remember in the early days when new magic sets would come out, we just finally figured out how to be the tops in the game. And then now they came out with new cards and this sucks. And David was like, no man, you're missing the boat. He's like, we have the skill of learning. That's really our skill. It's not like our skill is playing with such and such magic. That's very narrow. Our skill is learning, and he's always focused on learning. And right around when he retired from playing Magic, which was right around when he was 25, David had this major epiphany, this major understanding. See, Daryl Ferguson's in the audience. How's it going, Fergie? Good seeing him. But anyways, David had this major epiphany about learning, and he was so excited about it. I mean, I'm telling you guys, he was contacting our congressman, whatever it was. He was the dean at his college, which is UVA. He was telling everyone who would listen to him, and everybody ignored him, completely ignored him. You know, who's this punk kid? You know, what does he know about education? And, of course, now he's a multimillionaire because of it, but, you know, never mind. But anyways, here was the idea, and it flows right into what Cotton's doing. I think it's literally incredible with this mentor program. I'm glad everyone's getting behind it. I'm glad Steven's getting behind it. I'm glad Derek's getting behind it. I'm behind it. I am behind it, Cotton. I think it's great. Because what David's idea was, and this is one of the kind of the core premises of OMG, is that people basically learn best when students like learn from each other. And so I'll give you an example of this. If you were to take a traditional classroom setting, okay, a traditional classroom with a teacher and 20 students or whatever, if you were instead of having just the teacher talk at the students, okay, just talk at them, blah, 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 you know, this thing about chemistry, this thing about biology, whatever it is. Instead of just having the teacher talk at the students, which is obviously marginally effective, whine about why the schools aren't good, you know, but anyways, whatever. Instead of just that, what they should do, what David realized is that at the beginning of the day, they should divide the class into two parts. And half of the class should just go off and do something enjoyable and productive and whatever, just kind of chill and just do something kind of enjoyable and interactive and interesting. And then the teacher would teach the other half of the class, the lesson of the day, whatever it is, like, you know, certain things with backlinks or whatever, SEO, or, snowballing when it comes to client getting, or how to properly handle reviews with Amazon, whatever it is. So the teacher would teach half the class the lesson, and then the half that learned the lesson during the second half of the day, the half that learned the lesson would teach that lesson to the students that had been kind of chilling out for the rest of the day, right? So now there's kind of straw man arguments against this. A straw man argument is like something that's not really thought out, just kind of like a ethic argument or whatever. Sort of like, oh, you know, We should have taxes because we need roads. You know, oh, okay, so we need roads, so we should enslave people. That sounds great. You know, like that's a straw man argument. So the straw man argument is, oh, well, maybe my kid is going to get paired off with a stupid kid, and that's going to be bad, and they're not going to learn. That's not really the way it works. And in fact, everybody incredibly benefits. And this is one of the core ideas. In fact, Cotton, I maintain that one of the reasons why you learn so effectively was that you realized that you were going to have to be kind of schooling your clients as to how you would have to teach them. And this is one of the powerful things that you do in your Velvet Ropes methodology, that it's literally brilliant to me. It's amazing to me. is the way that you structure and educate your clients. And you are also at the same time willing to learn from your clients and gain from them. Inside of OMG, you know, you like immediately, right away, you were teaching me about SEO client consulting from the very first time, the very, very, very first time, first webinar you were on, first time I got on the phone with you. You were both educating me and you're willing to absorb that information. You know, one of the premises of OMG is we knew we were going to be mixing people who are already literally incredible at something. You take, look guys, Daryl Ferguson, I mean, yeah, he's 67 years old and he came in and had a lot of success. You know, that wasn't blind luck. I mean, Daryl was a Top Gun salesperson. He sold a Corvettes, like a lot of them. He sold like more Corvettes than anybody, okay? The guy knows how to make sales. Now, does that mean that he knew SEO? No. He had to learn SEO from Greg and from, you know, from Fletch and from Cotton and so forth. But then did that mean that Daryl has nothing to pass on to other people? That's crazy. That's crazy. He's literally amazing. I've learned a lot about sales from Daryl. He's brilliant at it, okay? Just really makes things simple. He goes from the gut. It really, really matters. And so mentorship, it's so brilliant, and OMG is so brilliant. You take Joe Marfolio. Joe came into OMG. Listen, Joe had made as much as $100,000 in a single month with SEO client consulting when he joined OMG. But we wanted OMG to be an attractive place for him to come and join because we want to, hey, Steven, you were no noob off the street when Cotton recruited you to come in and join OMG, but you also literally recognized that there was opportunity for you inside of OMG, both as a student and as a mentor. I mean, it seemed like, because right away you were doing that.
Immediate opportunity.
It was, the door was really open to you. You know, there's other places where, you know, folks would feel like you're stepping on their toes or, oh, know your role, you know, get to the side or, you know, where a teacher is just a teacher, a student is just a student, the end. And we don't have that inside of OMG. That breeds disrespect. It does. Like when I feel like I can't learn from Steven or Derek or Daryl, when I feel like I can't learn from Angela, then I'm closing my mind off. You know, when I feel like I can't, how much worse of a place would OMG have been if me and David Mills and Greg Morrison and Fletch didn't feel like we could learn a lot from Cotton? Like give me the number. I don't know, you always make up all these crazy numbers. Give me a hashtag mind blown if you feel like OMG would literally be a far worse place if we hadn't been able to learn from Cotton. Because I'm going to do, I mean, I think that OMG would be a far worse place if we weren't designed to have Cotton come in and educate us and bring things to life for us. And of course, you know, in the same way, what did Cotton do? Cotton, you know, he didn't come in and say, oh, you guys are stupid. You guys know nothing what's going on. Let me show you how it's done. Cotton came inside. He was ready to both learn and to teach. And you know, Cotton, I kind of threw something out there, and I wanted to ask you about it. You came in and had to equip yourself to not just to educate your clients, which I believe made you more attentive, a better student, and so forth, of your OMG teaching. But also, you've learned not just from me and from Greg, you've learned from Fletch, other OMGers, and you've learned from your clients as well. I mean, does that ring true to you?
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
I always try to learn from everyone.
Yeah. Oh, am I kind of getting feedback? Yeah. Is it kind of jacked up?
Yeah.
Sorry about
that. Yeah.
Oh, shoot. So I went on that long rant and it was all like kind of for naught?
No. We can
hear you. When I talk, they can hear me.
Oh, when you're talking, you're getting an echo back. Okay, I'll just mute myself. And I've said my piece. But you know, I see all the hashtag mind blown, and I'm just going to kick back and enjoy this event as an attendee, just like everybody else, and hear what Cotton has to say. But I am absolutely behind this mentorship program. OMG is designed because you never know when the next quote unquote newbie is going to turn right around and change your life the way that Cotton's changed our lives, the way that Steven is changing our lives, the way that Derek's changing our lives. So many OMGers, the way Liz is changing our lives. It's just a wonderful system. OMG is a city on a hill. It is a place where friends come together in Providence. If you're down with what I just said, give me a hashtag, hill, and I'm going to just fade out and become an enjoyable attendee.
All right, thanks, Mike. It's always great to have you on, man. But, yeah, Mike, like, made some valid points. You know, I, like, learned a tremendous amount from Steven. You know, but what I've always did is, guys, find someone that you can trade information with. You know, Steven is – and Derek both are just absolutely mind-blowing as far as their information and knowledge and stuff. And I've learned more from these two over the last 60 days than I've probably learned from anybody. And hopefully they've learned something from me. But that's what they do also. And if you'll look, Derek, you know, he tries to get with Jimmy and other people and trade information back and forth. That's how you do, guys. You, like, get enough information where you can start trading up and getting more information for people that are at another level than what you are. And, you know, for you to get Steven's information, you have to get information from other people, start from the ground up, and then Steven will open up to you once, you know, you're on his level. But Steven is very giving, Derek's very giving, and I'm very giving. And you can learn from anyone, guys. And this is one of the things that I'm going to say before we brought Mike on. It's always amazing to have Mike on, is that please listen. If you want a mentor, go out and get it done. Now, they did have one person ask me to be a mentor, and I can tell you that I'll answer any question that, like, comes to my inbox, but I really don't have the time to mentor anyone, to give the time and attention to it. So, but that doesn't mean that you can't try and ask. So what I'm saying is, guys, it doesn't matter how high level it is in OMG, we'll always respond to your message. And if you need a question, I'm always going to answer it for you. I answer every message that comes in my inbox. And just be aggressive in going out and getting a mentor. This is your career. This is your money. This is your life. If you want to sit and wait on someone to drop that money in your lap, it's never going to happen. I've never had it happen. You got to go out and you got to get it. So if you have something, if you have a skill, or even if you're a newbie, please. And you know what? I just seen that Orlando just commented on there. That was the one person that asked me. Orlando Gonzalez. He's the only person to ask me to mentor him. And so that's what's funny. So guys, please be aggressive. Go out, find someone that's got some information, trade it with them, get together, start making some money. If you hate sales, get someone, you know, that wants to do sales, and let them go out and sell for you. Guys, remember, if you fail finding someone to hook up with, it's just like any other business relationship. Not everyone's meant to be business partners. Not everyone's meant to be together. Just be patient and go find someone that you click with. You're not going to click with everyone, and not everyone's going to have the same business ideas and stuff. So it might take you a couple people to find the right fit for yourself, to where you can partner up with someone good. But just because you failed once doesn't mean you stop trying. I mean, there's great fits everywhere. So just remember that, and I'm going to stop my rant. So we're going to get on to the lesson. So we got two pretty mind-blowing lessons ready still, and we're an hour and a half in. One's from Steven and one's from me. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go first, and I'm going to close this down with Steven. So we're going to stay on our mobile apocalypse, and we're going to stay on anything, guys. This is going to pertain to absolutely anything. Give me a number four if you think that email is an effective way to cold call anybody. Look at that. Do you see that, guys? There's nothing. Oh, hold on. Negative fours. Well, guys, how many of you are actually checking your open rates on these emails? Give me a seven. If you're checking your open rates, give me a seven. Well, there's a few. Give me, I want to know, just say yes. How many of you are getting your emails open? Just type in yes or no. Yes, yes. There's a lot of yeses. Now, guys, what if I told you this? What if I told you that I had a way to get you in front of the client and to pitch to them and do it all through email? Would you be interested? Give me a yes if you'd be interested. Absolutely. Guys, this is what I was able to do over the last few weeks. And I knew that I needed to step this up to help you guys out. I went deep into research and development, wanted to find out. And I started it about 2.5 weeks ago that everyone was complaining that their emails were stale, this and that. So I went out and I found something for you that is literally, I think, is going to help you out tremendously. Guys, how many of you would agree that video is very powerful to sell? Give me a number 5. Everyone's given 5s here. It's pretty powerful across there. Guys, I'm going to show you a service that I found. It's called BombBomb. What if I told you that I'm sending out video emails to get my clients? I'm pitching my clients from inside of my email. Does that sound cool? Give me a number 6. Absolutely. Guys, this right here should blow your mind when I'm going to do it. What BombBomb is, it's a very inexpensive service. It's $49 a month, and I started to use it. Now, I'm going to show you exactly what it does, and I'm going to walk you through it a little bit. So just kind of bear with me a little bit. So what it does is it integrates right into Gmail. So what I did is I set up a little starter account here. So what happens is if I want to compose an email, I'd like come over here, and I'm just going to send this one to myself. And right here, and the subject is, and I'm just going to type in something, massive Google update on April 21st. Are you ready? Just something simple. I mean, I'm just doing this for the sake of this. Now, if you can see this right here, there's a little bomb right here. So I go here, and notice this pops up. And I'm going to click on the select video. I'm going to select a video, and I'm going to hit this, and I'm going to hit insert video. Now look what happens. This right here. So what happens is that now I hit send, and if you'll see what happens, this is exactly what it looks like. It sent massive Google update April 21st. Are you ready? So when I open this up, here's what it looks like. Now, obviously, this is a very big picture. You probably see the pores on my face. This picture is so big. I did this very quickly just to show you guys. Now, what happens when you click on it, look at what it goes to. It automatically goes to the video, and it starts playing it. So, guys, I want you to tell me, how powerful do you think this is going to be if you did a quick 1 or 2 minute video and explain this to your client? Give me a 3. Exactly. Video email is how I'm getting all of these people to respond to me. Now, the cool part about it is remember, let's go back to my email again. So it automatically put a play button right there, and it said everything that I wanted it to do. So let's go try it again, and let's just do it with another one. So let me send another one to myself, and let's just do test, and let's just do test. You can put anything right here also. You can put all your sales copy, whatever you want to put right there. I'm going to click on the bomb again. And from the bomb, it's going to bring up all the emails that you uploaded. So we're going to go in and select a video. I'm just going to do this one. I'm going to put insert. And we're going to send it. And as you can see, we will go ahead and do the inbox again. Here it is. Right there it is. And all you have to do is click it, and it goes right there. And it starts playing everything immediately, as you can see. And this is how I'm able to get in front of my clients through email. And when they see that, guys, everyone's always curious about everything and what they're doing. They will click on this. I'm getting a massive click-through rate, and I'm getting everything amazing. So let's go back to the software right here and show you even how this can even be done a little bit better. So what we do is let's say that we have a video that we want to upload. And I'm going to show you how it's even cool. So let's say that we want to upload a new video, and I want the new title here, Google Update. And I'm just doing this very, very quickly for the sake of everything. So I can also record a video live right now, and it'll do it, and I can put it in there. So I'm going to pick a video. I'm going to go over here, and let's just go into my downloads right here, and I'm going to find one. Let's just go with this one. So I upload it, and I want to show you what it does. It's going to take a little bit to upload it, But what it's going to do is it's actually going to mobile optimize for all search engines. And I'm going to show you here in a second exactly what it does and why it's very powerful. Because it wants to play it. This will even play it through mobile. So what I'm saying is even if they open up their email through their cell phones or whatever else, they're able to play it. So it takes a while for it to process. But what happens is you can see right here, it's encoding for 3P Android. There is a 3G video playback in Android, Firefox, a low desktop, a mid desktop, or an iPhone. It figures out what you need to do. Then what you do is you pick your thumbnail, you decide where you want the play button to go. Obviously, you could do it in the middle or the side. This is where they're probably going to see the first thing that's going to catch their eyes, upper right-hand corner or the middle. And you pick the thumbnail that you want with the video description. So with this, I found this to be very, very, very powerful and very effective. Sending client messages, sending a canned email, guys. You can sit back and do a 1 to 2 minute video about this Google update, which I have done, and send it to individual clients. And I want you to tell me if you think that this is something. Yes, I've like seen some questions here. Yes, it has analytics. It tells you who opens it up. It tells you who looks at it. Give me number four if you think that this can help your success with selling mobile apocalypse. Exactly. Give me a number seven if you just don't think this is your thing and it's just not going to work. Yeah, I'm not getting any. You know, guys, if like this is something that, how like many of you have had any experience with video email before? I want you to give me a number one. Some of you has. Guys, if this is not blowing your mind right now, you know what? I think we should go over to the Facebook group. This is blowing your mind. Come over here and give a hashtag mind blown if you think that this can help you. And I only want you to put it on there if you think this is going to help your conversions with everything. Not just mobile apocalypse, but getting clients itself. That if you were to show, and I'm going to show you some more about this product of why it's so powerful, because you're able to come through and absolutely they can see you. They can hear you. They know who you are. You're talking directly to them. Why it's not more impactful than a black and white text email. This is something that is going to change your game and going out and getting clients. Now, I've done this the long way and sent emails and, you know, embedded things in there, but I wanted to do something that's very, very, very easy for you guys. So a lot of people saying hashtag mind blown, that's good. We're going to go back. I'm going to show you some more stuff that's like going to blow you away also. So when you come over here and when you do a quick send, I want you to watch what happens. With this quick send right here, look at what happens here. I have right now the subject, I can change it, but it says video email from Cotton Grammar Search Engine Marketing. And if you notice right here, if I hit allow, I can now record live right now a message from my webcam on my iMac and put it in there live. So in essence, if you're a good talker, you can sit there and have your script ready and you can just start over and say, hey, Jim, this is Cotton. I wanted to let you know that there's a very important Google update that's going to be coming on April 21st, and it's going to affect all websites. And I've included the link below for you to check a look at and look to see how badly it's being talked about all over the internet. If you please get back to me, I've included my 800 number below. I will be more than happy to fix this for you for free. I just wanted to reach out and let you know I didn't want you to lose all your mobile traffic and all your possible revenue. Reach out to me on the number below. I look forward to talking to you soon. Bye. You record the video, send it out. It's got my logo in here. It's got a picture of me. It's got my contact information. You can set all this up quickly. Now, even what's more cool about these guys is you can go over here and you can have a customized landing page. Now, you don't have to do this. I'm not telling you to do this. But when you come over here, you can go to their concierge. And what they will do is they will build a customized landing page for you that when you show your email, it will – I'm trying to find it right here, their tech store. They can build it for you. No, that's not it. What they're basically going to do is build a whole landing page for you. You're like custom design. And I've like already talked to the owner of the company. What it is you can white label. You can get everything off there for $10 a month. You don't need to do this if you don't want to. But their concierge program, what they'll do is they'll go out And instead of having this page right here that's all white, I don't mind all this white right here. They'll go out and customize this with logos, 800 numbers, everything on here for $250. So every time that you use it, you'll have something customized. You know, like instead of me going out here and having this, so when I do this quick send, I can have my logo all the way around or looking just like cottongrammar.com and it'll send it out. So this is just kind of a brief summary of what you can do with this and how you can do it. Guys, this also works amazing for mobile phones. So in other words, if you log into your BombBomb account, you can flip over your iPhone or your Android phone. You can record a message. I know I've seen a lot of you do this and just go, hey, you know, I'm outside right now. I wanted to let you know. You can send that message, birthday messages, anything. This just can't be used with sales. It can be used with anything. So with this, if you go out and you do one good solid video on anything that you want to do about getting clients, let's say you're just focusing on people with the mobile apocalypse, you would do a quick video about that in your office, just look presentable, edit it up a little bit, make it, I say make them short, make them about a minute to 2 minutes. You don't want to ramble on for 4 or 5 minutes, especially if someone's on their mobile phone. You want to intrigue them, get in and get out. I've been able to close another 6 clients last week doing this. So with that, guys, if you think that you, and yes, you can white label this stuff also with your own stuff. So guys, if you think that this could be a powerful component of your client getting, give me a number 8 right now. Absolutely. Absolutely. Putting yourself in front of the client immediately. Now, I didn't want to show you my email that I'm like sending out because I want you guys to be creative on your own. But, you know, you can have one like Becker does it, I do it, with right in the middle of you talking. So it even entices them more to want to click on it, one that's in action. So I encourage you that if you're going to be marketing people, whether mobile apocalypse is going to come and go 6 months from now, it's going to be harder to get clients this way. We're staying on it while it's hot right now. But if you're even trying to go out and prospect clients, or even if you want to let a client know or do a video, you can record your video, put it in this and send it to them, and it'll take them there. It has full analytics on what goes on, how many people opened it up, how long they looked at it, everything. This has all of it. You can even come over here and drip the videos out whenever you want. So you can do drips here. It shows you how to do it. You can go and you can build forms. There's all this sort of stuff it teaches you how to do. You can import your lists in, and it integrates in. What it is this also has a tracking to let you test your relationship when you send your email out. Who's opened it up? So you can look at, if you send out 100 emails, you can glance through and it's going to have an icon by them. Green if they opened it up. Or if you've sent out 5 emails and they opened up all 5, it's going to be green. If you sent out 5 emails to them and they didn't open one, it's going to have this orange one right here. So it has analytics on that. It has everything that you would want. And you can save your emails. You can have templates, all this sort of stuff. It's a very powerful and robust system for beginners. Can you go out and do this your own for free, embed the email in there, run it over to a landing page, you lift yourself? Absolutely. Do I think this can cut off your learning curve and getting stuff done very quickly? Yes. Service runs about $49.99. We have no affiliation with these people. I did talk to the owner of the company, and I was very impressed with what he showed me a couple weeks ago, and it's a very, very, very powerful service, guys. I think that video email, I don't think that there's a lot of SEOs that are taking it to this level. This is why you're finding right now that I'm going to start revealing some key things that I'm doing to get better conversions, more clients, and how I'm able to ramp up faster. You always have to stay ahead of the game. And I think this is one of the most powerful ways to do it. So guys, if you've enjoyed this, you know, give me a number 9. Let me know if you've got something out of this. Great. Looks like everyone enjoyed it. And that's my lesson right there is, guys, check out BombBomb, and it's pretty simple. It's B-O-M-B, B-O-M-B, no affiliate with them, not making any money off of it. I do use this myself, and as you can see, it works fantastic. You know, this is what it's going to look like when they open up their email from even a mobile phone or anywhere. It's a much more powerful way to get someone to click through and get your message across, the basic nasty black and white text. So this should be able to amp up your client getting ways, tremendously, whether it be Mobilepocalypse or anything else. So hopefully you guys enjoyed that. Steven, my friend, I'm going to turn this over to you. And
No. That is not fair. That is not fair. I do not want to follow that. That is totally not fair.
Oh, dude, it's so fair. Because you have something that is equally going to blow their minds. So, guys, if you thought that this is going to amp up your client getting, Steven's going to go over something. You want to tell him what the topic is, Steven?
Penalties.
Guys, if you want to know about penalties, give me a hashtag show me for Steven to let him know. Just hashtag show me. Because he's going to go over some stuff that I'm not quite sure that I've seen in OMG before. And this is now when we're going to take it crazy. So, Steven, what about penalties are you going to talk about? And I just want you to tell them so we can get – we have over 300 people on this webinar. I want to know what you're going to go over, and we need about 200 show me's for you to keep going. What's this penalty stuff about?
Well, listen, one of the things that I try to do is keep a pulse on kind of what people are asking and what they want to hear about, and maybe things that the training hasn't been created for yet and things like that. And what I see, honestly, maybe one of the most things has to do with penalties and sites being indexed and de-indexed, and how do you know, how do you tell, what do you do? So that's kind of what I'm going to cover is – I'm going to go over, the basic types of penalties, how you can tell what kind you have, and then some action steps. And listen, guys, there's a lot of new members right now. I think there's like 8 million new people that have signed up, which is awesome, in the last, maybe the last month. And so, I'm going to step by step, okay? I'm going to show some stuff like, you don't even know what a plugin is, all right? So, but for those of you who do and are a little bit more advanced, I think that I have some things that will be helpful for you as well.
You need the presenter?
Yeah. Hey, before you switch it over to me, man, I got to tell you, I'm a little irritated that you didn't show me that bomb thing before. I mean, man, gosh, I gotta stay up late now and set that thing up. There's one person, man, I want to point out. Man, I'm going to miss it now. I don't know where she is. I just hashtagged her. But when you put that in, she put in there that she's got a client that she can for. And I'm looking through the thread now on Facebook, and I can't find it. But I wanted to point that out. Man, that's the way to be thinking. You know, when Cotton shows you a tool like this, don't think, just copy Cotton, right? I mean, copy Cotton is great, right? But think about it. He's never going to show you a tool or a service that doesn't have multiple uses and multiple applications. And man, I can't find the post, but I know you're there somewhere. But man, that's the way to be thinking. When you see something like this, look at it and go, man, there you are, Kathy Bay. Thank you, Kathy. Mm-hmm. That's what I want to see. You know, I mean, think about this. Think about all the ways that your client could use this, right? Your potential client.
You know, man, what? I mean, we not to interrupt you, Steve, but we just brought on another super special superstar. And I mean superstar onto the webinar right now. I'm going to ask him, did you get a chance to see this bomb stuff? And what do you think, special guest superstar?
Are you talking to me, Con?
Oh, well, of course I'm talking to you. It's fine.
Well, you know what? I do have certain privileges that you actually reached out to me a couple days ago and mm-hmm. and asked me if I'd been using this just because I'm using video pretty heavily, and I was like, dude, no, this is totally game changer. So I checked into it. I got signed up for the trial period. It's like 14 mm-hmm. days or something, but sure. It's pretty cool. With me, I think a lot of the people in OMG know that, I'm pretty much about transparency, and even more than that, one of the key factors, and everybody on here, Steven, Cotton, the people that I've heard speak just since I jumped on, I had to go to dinner with my family.
I've been involved with OMG long enough to kind of see that, you know, there's certain people that get in and they do well really quickly, and there's other people who, you know, 6 months after the fact are like, I got to earn money. I got to do this. And one of the key factors I've started to be able to discern out of that whole thing is that you've got to stop thinking about how you can earn money and start thinking about how you can deliver value.
Bam. Mm-hmm.
And this is one of those ways you can deliver value to a customer that gets the door opened, that lets you be a service provider, that lets you serve a customer, deliver value, and really be able to provide something that's worth money. And there's so many people that want to just get before they give. And this is something that flips that, you know, kind of technologically. But when that mindset shifts, that's when it all changed for me. So I'm really happy you brought this out to the group today, Cotton, Steven. Just based on that, I would be, you know, certainly happy to hear where this goes from here.
Sure.
Especially if we, you know, kind of focus in on that mindset shift of where can you deliver value? This is one of those things you can deliver value on, and you can do it, you know, transparently, congruently. You know, this is you speaking to somebody that you can help, and it's one of those things that's an incredible tool for that. So really, you know, stoked to be involved with just helping get the word out about this. So awesome to you, Cotton, Steven.
Great.
Take it away, my friends.
Guys, if you always enjoy hearing from Fletch, and if you understood what he said, give me a hashtag value. Value. Oh, value, guys. Come on. Fletch just decided to just pop on, give his free time, and drop some knowledge with us. Let him know. And that's like true, guys. It's one of the things that I learned from Fletch. It's very valuable. Is if you've ever watched any of Fletch's videos, you know that he's very sincere coming across it, and that he's really caring about you through that video. And I'm going to tell you, that's why Fletch cranks out the cash. So, you know, if you can show people that you care and that comes through that video, now's your point, because how cold and calloused is black and white text and someone's opening it up? They just throw it by the wayside. I do it. But you know what? When I see a possible video in there, or someone smiling, or you know that someone's working on a whiteboard or something like that, or you know what's even cool is I just thought up with this idea right here. What if you got on a whiteboard and took a picture of yourself and go massive Google update April 21st? You can put whatever thumbnail you want on these videos. Are you going to tell me that they're not going to want to click on that to see what's going on? I mean, people are just too curious not to. So that's an idea right there that I hadn't even thought of. So, you know, just Fletch just inspired me with that idea right there about offering value. So what I'm saying is, guys, and just please offer the value, and, you know, always happy to have Fletch on here. And we'll turn it back over to Steven, and he's going to talk about some crazy penalty stuff that you guys are literally going to be blown away by the time he gets done, because I've heard a little bit of this. So sorry to interrupt you, Steven. Please push on.
Hey, anytime Fletch is interruption, please, please, please interrupt.
Exactly.
Man, talk about it. Interruption. Every time that guy talks, I feel like I learn something, or I just feel better. I don't know what it is. Just, man, I just love that guy.
I agree.
All right, yeah, will you give me the presenter, and I'll jump over.
Let me do that. Make presenter. You should be able to take control.
All right. Let's see. Is it showing me yet? Hold on.
I don't see it yet.
Do here. All right. Let's see here. All right, guys. Give me a 3 if you can hear me okay.
We can hear you.
Light me up with. All right.
I can't see your screen yet.
All right. Let's see.
Hold on. How about I click on the other screen and then I can see it? You think that would be cool? All right.
All right. Guys, give me a 4 if you can see my screen.
4.
Oh. Give me a 4. All right. Just Derek. All right. Yeah, so I'm just joking, guys. All right. Appreciate it. Thanks, Derek, for chiming in. All right, guys, listen. So you know, like Cotton mentioned in the beginning, and like I said also, you know, we really want to answer the questions that you guys are asking, right? That's why, and guys, I'll tell you, I belong to several other SEO groups really as a coach, and nothing is even close to OMG. It's just not. I don't even know, like, you couldn't even compare the two. It'd be apples and oranges. And one of the things that sticks out like a sore thumb is, you know, the QA stuff. Like, who does hour and a half long QAs? Like, nobody does hour and a half long QAs, right? So I hope you guys all appreciate being here. I know I certainly do. You know, this is the best investment I've ever made in my business, to be honest with you. So with that being said, let me jump into this. So one of the questions that I see frequently has to do with penalties and domains being indexed or not indexed and things like that. So I made a handy-dandy PowerPoint that's, I'm sure, awesome. So let me go through these slides kind of quickly, and then I'm going to demonstrate some things, and then we'll do QA at the end, okay? So if you ask a question while I'm doing this middle thing, I'm not going to see it or answer it till we're done, okay? My brain can't do that. So let me go ahead and get started on here. All right, so one example could be you bought a domain to use for your PBN, or you may have bought it for your money site, and after a reasonable amount of time, it will not index, okay? So first question is, what does it mean for your website to be indexed? So guys, give me a 4 if you don't know what it means when I say, is your site indexed or not? Give me a 4 if you don't understand what that means. Okay, all right, so and that's awesome, okay? So let me tell you in a nutshell, when someone says that, what they mean is when someone goes to Google and they search for your site, is it going to appear in Google's search engine results? Okay, is and some of these things are not textbook definitions. I'm gonna make them where I hope they're easier to understand. So please don't be nitpicky. There could be little nitpicky things about what I'm saying that 100% accurate, okay, but I'm presenting it in a simple way, so hopefully everyone will understand. So basically, when someone says, is your site indexed, it means if I go to Google and I search for it by name, will it come up? Does Google include it in its index of websites? Okay, so give me a 5 if you understand that now, and give me a 6 if you don't. Give me a 6 if you're still not sure. And sixers are okay, guys. No one knows who, you know, but you, okay? So I don't think maybe just 1 or 2, okay? So the reason why you want your sites to be indexed is because if they're not, it means that people can't find you in Google. So it's very important that they're indexed in Google so people can find your site. Now, if it's a money site, obviously, and a money site is the site that you want traffic to go to, it's the site that you want to promote, you want to have visibility, then if it's not in Google, people can't find you, so you can't, you know, make any sales. If it's a private work site, then that means if it's not indexed, that it may not be providing the value that you want. So give me a 3 if you don't know what I mean when I say a private blog network site. Give me a 3 if you're not sure what that is. And again, remember, guys, there's nothing wrong with all right, so a few people here. Okay, so that's going to be a little bit outside of the scope of this webinar, but here's the good news. Greg Morrison is going to be doing some additional training on this, and he covers this thoroughly. In fact, he's the authority as far as I'm concerned about this topic, period. And so in your sink or swim section is where you're going to find this training. And also in other sections. So to be simplistic, a private blog network site is a website that you use to make your site more powerful, okay? And so again, I won't go into that in more detail, but trust me, Greg is the man. He's better than anyone at this, so you can get that inside of OMG. All right, so the next question that we would ask is, how can you tell if it's indexed? How do I know this? All right, and so the easiest way to tell if your site is indexed is to use what's called a Google search operator, and that's just a fancy way of saying that you're going to search Google a specific way, and the one that you're going to want to use, again, it's not the only one, is going to be site, S-I-T-E, colon, and then the domain. So if I wanted to know if this site was here, then I would type site, colon, and then the domain. So I'm going to give you an example. So this is a site that I use for testing. And so I'm going to go to Google here, and I'm going to type site, colon, and then I'm going to put in that domain, and I'm going to hit enter. And when I do, this is what comes up. Did not match any documents. So it means this site is not in Google's index. So people who are searching for this will not find it. Okay. Now, they can still directly go to it. If I type this directly in here, you can still go to the site. Google doesn't own the internet, but it does own its search engine. So no one is ever going to find this site here by searching Google. Okay? So as a, you know, as a different example, let's just say, you know, what? CNN.com. Okay? So when I do that, you see that the first result that comes up is CNN.com. Okay? And so, and there are 3,860,000 results. Okay? So there's, and it looks like CNN has 656,000 pages that are indexed, okay? So that is the basic way that you can tell, all right? So give me a 4 if you're with me so far. Give me a 4 if you're with me so far. Give me a 5 if you're not. Give me a 5 if you're kind of like still not sure about all this. Okay, all right, so mostly 4s but a little bit of 5s. All right, so let me go on to the next thing here real quick, and then I'm going to go into, you know, some how you do things next, okay? So what is a Google penalty, okay? So you're going to hear a lot of talk about that from people in SEO circles and in OMG. They're going to ask, is my site penalized? Did I suffer a penalty? Okay, and what that means is it means that I put here a site that has a penalty will lose visibility in Google search engine results, okay? So what that means is a site with a penalty, it can either be completely gone from Google, or it can be have parts of it that are gone from Google, okay? So it's important to understand that. Your site could be completely missing from Google, or only parts of it could be missing from Google, all right? So let me go on to the next part. So there are two basic types of penalties that you are likely to get, all right? So the first one is what we call an algorithmic penalty, all right? And that means that Googlebot, which is a piece of software that visits your site, thinks that you basically broke the rules, okay? So, you know, Googlebot is a piece of software, and it goes to your website, and it crawls all around it, and it basically looks at lots of different things, okay? And if it determines that your site is violating Google's terms, meaning that it's cheating, basically, then Googlebot can then give that information back to Google, who can then, you know, penalize your site. So again, penalty meaning that either your site is completely not in Google anymore, or certain pages are not in Google anymore, okay? And so this is something that runs all the time, okay? Googlebot software, every time it visits your site, you be looking for these things, okay? So the next type of penalty is a manual penalty, all right? And a manual penalty is the main difference, the thing that you want to key in on is that this means that a member of Google's spam team, so a human being, has actually looked at your site and determined that it is violating a term of service, okay? Now, there are some exceptions to this, okay, but again, you know, we could be here for 10 years to go over every exception. So what I want you to get from this is, in general, most of the time, if your site has a penalty, it's either going to be from an algorithm, meaning that Googlebot found something it didn't like, or a manual penalty, which means that Google found something it didn't like and an actual human looked at your site, okay? And that is why, and it's very important that we understand which one of these that we have, because the way it is going to be very different. All right? So, guys, again, I know this is maybe a little technical for some of y'all. So, you know, give me a 5 if you're pretty much, you know, on board and you got what I'm talking about. Give me a 6 if you're like, I'm not sure what's going on. I'm still kind of confused. Okay, so it looks like almost 100% 6s. Okay, that's awesome. I mean 5s. Yeah, pretty much awesome. Okay. All right, so next thing. So here's the thing that you need to know. Here's why it's really important to know whether you have an algorithmic penalty or a manual penalty, okay? Because if you have an algorithmic penalty and you fix what Google is mad at you about, then you can recover from it, okay? You can recover without, you know, doing anything other than fixing what they, you know, don't like. However, if you have a manual penalty, then the way that you're going to get out of that is you have to fix wrong, and then you have to let Google know, all right? And I'm going to go over that in more detail, okay? So if you didn't quite understand that part, don't worry. I'm going to go into more detail. But the reason why it's important, again, is because what you're going to do, the actions you're going to take are going to be different based on whether it's a manual penalty or an algorithmic penalty, all right? So here's what we're going to do. And I will go ahead, I can paste these into the at the end, guys, okay? Or you can take screenshots or whatever, okay? So here's what you're going to do to check to see if you have a manual penalty. The one great thing about a manual penalty is that you can 100% verify it. So if you have a manual penalty, you're not guessing what happened. You know that you have a penalty, and you know why. So, you know, knowledge is power, all right? So I would say there's actually some advantages to a manual penalty in that aspect. So the first thing that you're going to need to do is you are going to need to have access to Google Webmaster Tools. And in order to do that, you're going to have a Gmail account, okay? So the first step would be create a Gmail account and then log into Webmaster Tools. Okay, or if you have already have a Gmail account, you can use it. But so let's say that you bought a domain and you don't know if it's good or bad. Okay, and you're not sure. Then in one of your Gmail accounts, it's better to go ahead and create one. Okay, it's better to go ahead and create, you know, what we would call a throwaway account. Okay, and I'll explain why in a minute. All right, so create a Gmail account. And then you are going to log in here, which is google.com/webmasters/tools, okay? That's what you're going to do, all right? And so once you do that, what you're going to be looking at is this is what the back-end screen looks like, okay? Some test sites, so I don't mind if you guys want to look at them or whatever, okay? These are just part of my test network. So if this were empty, then your option would be add a site, okay? So I'm going to click add a site, and the site that I'm going to, you know, add here, again, is going to be my my demo site, all right? So I'm going to simply put the URL in here without the www, I mean without the HTTP, okay? And I'm going to hit continue. All right, and now Google is going to tell me that I have to verify that I own this site, all right? And there's different ways you can verify, all right? Here's, you know, the recommended method, and then here's the alternate methods, all right? And there's multiple different ways to do this, okay? And so I'm not going to teach you all the different ways to do that. I am going to show you one way that's very quick and easy, and I'm going to show you how to do it with WordPress, because, again, that's what most of you guys are using, okay? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to choose add tag to your site's homepage, and I'm going to copy all of this. And guys, this is going to be in the slides. Okay, all this is going to be in the slides. So don't worry about, you know, memorizing this right while we're sitting here. Okay, so I'm going to copy. So again, I went to alternate methods, HTML tag, and then I copied this long string here. Okay, so now I went back to my WordPress, and I'm already logged in, and I go to Plugins, Add New. multiple ways to do this, guys. I'm just going to show you one, okay? So, all right. And for this, I typed in Google Verify. Now, if you type in other things, you can get there as well. Webmaster Verify, Webmaster Tools Verify, it doesn't matter. But I know when you type in Google Verify that this is going to come up right here, okay? And it's Verify Google Webmaster Tools. It should be fairly simple by this guy, and I'm not going to try to say his name. I would probably just chew it up, all right? So we logged into the back end of our site in WordPress. We went to Plugins, Add New. We Google Verify, and then this comes up, Verify Google Webmaster Tools. So I'm going to click Install Now. You sure you wish to install this plugin? Okay. And I'm going to let that go ahead and install. And then I'm going to go ahead and activate it. All right. So now that it's activated, I'm going to go over here to Settings and Google Webmaster Tools. And right here it says paste your Google Webmaster Tools code in here. All right. And I'm going to paste it in here. And there's different plugins that do different things. Sometimes you paste this entire thing in here and it works. And sometimes you will only paste just the part in between here, where after the content. So let me see if that's this one. Each one does it a little bit different. So let me see if that's it. So we save that. I go back to Webmaster Tools, and I click Verify. Okay? And let's see if that did it. All right. So that did it. Now, if you do a different plugin, again, and it doesn't say, it says fail verification, then come back here and take out everything before this content. Just use just this code. Okay, and again, this code is going to be unique for your site. All right, so now the site is verified, and we're going to say continue. All right, so what we're going to navigate to now is going to be search traffic and manual actions. Okay, search traffic, actions. Now, what you want to see on this is no manual web spam found. And I'll put that in the PowerPoint. No manual web spam found. If you see anything else but that, then you have a penalty. Okay? Guys, give me a 6 if you can read my screen fairly easily. All right, give me a 6 if you see that. All right, so it says site-wide matches. Some manual actions apply. Our site, okay? Pure spam. Pages on this site appear to be using aggressive spam techniques, such as automatically generated gibberish, cloaking, scraping content from other websites, and or repeated or egregious violations of Google Webmaster Guidelines. Surely not. I mean, I wouldn't do that, right? Give me a 4 if you know I wouldn't do that. There's no way I'm going to do that. I'm not going to violate any of Google's terms, right? No way. Give me a 5 if you think I'm absolutely going to violate Google's terms. Give me a 5 if you think I do it on a daily basis and I really, really, really enjoy it. All right, so I'm not going to answer. I'm not going to tell you who was right. But here is what we're looking for, okay? So here's what we know now. We know that we have a manual penalty, okay? And we know why, okay? It's told us pure spam, and it's even told us why, okay? So I can pretty much tell you that if this was your site and it wasn't brand new and you get this penalty, you already know why. You know what you did, right? You did something you weren't supposed to and you got caught, right? It's all fun until you get caught, right? All fun until you get caught. So again, in this instance now, we don't have to guess, right? If we went and we looked up Lindemann and it didn't show up and we went, wow, it's not in the index, so something has to be wrong. Now that we've gone into Webmaster Tool and gone through all of these steps, now we have a verification. So the guessing game is over. No more do we have to ask in Facebook groups. I think I'm penalized, but I'm not sure. Now we have a verification. All right? So, guys, give me a 3 if this has been helpful for you so far. Give me a 3 if this has been helpful so far. And remember, this doesn't matter if it's money site or PBN or client. Client site. Okay? Don't forget your clients. Right? You know, you take on a new client, you know, you want to know if they're penalized or not, right? And so, you know, Greg did some great training recently on that as well, on some other ways to be able to tell. Okay. So,
you know what, Stephen, not to interrupt you, give me a 9 if you've never seen this before. If you've never seen a site that has a manual penalty like this before, give me a 9. Wow. So see, this is helpful to a lot of people. Look at that, Stephen.
So yeah, I was hoping it would be.
Right. So guys, this is almost invaluable information to actually see a site that has a manual penalty on it and what it looks like. So very valuable information, Steve. Please continue.
Thanks, Cotton. Yeah. I mean, honestly, 99% of the SEOs that you know have never seen this before. So it doesn't mean that they don't have these penalties. They just don't have any idea that this is here. So a lot of people will spin their wheels and waste actually months or years sometimes trying to get their clients' sites or their sites back when this is the case. And I'm going to go over why it's an exercise in futility. Okay. So let me go through to my next little thing here. All right. So let me go to – so now that we have a manual penalty, okay, the only way – okay, I want to highlight that, right? The only way to remove a manual penalty is to file a reconsideration request inside Webmaster Tools, okay? Now, there's people who will say different things, and there's different tricks, and there's different things, and I wouldn't argue with the entire internet. There's lots of ways to get out of penalties that are algorithmic. Getting out of manual ones, I would consider this pretty much gospel, guys. Okay, maybe someone like Jimmy, you know, Kelly, you know, people at his level. Well, who's at Jimmy's level, right? Maybe people that are really high level, you know some way around this. I don't know any ways around this, okay, if it's a manual penalty, okay? So here's what you need to do, all right, in a nutshell. So you see here that there's a little button here that says request a review, okay? So ultimately, you're going to click this button, all right? But the first thing that you need to do is you need to figure out why you got hit in the first place. Okay, and again, I'll tell you, typically you're doing one of these things that's here exactly. Okay, now this site, as an example, is one of my test sites, as I mentioned before. And if you go here and you check out the content, you're going to find something not very unique. It is not unique at all. It is straight up like copied, spun, ripped from other places. Okay? Nothing unique about this at all. So when Googlebot went here, they're like, this site is just a complete ripoff of something else, some other sites, right? So, you know, Googlebot says, well, we don't want to present this, right? This is not valuable. This is not something that people would find value in. So we are going to remove it from our search engine results, right? So if I were going to recover this site, okay, and so like some of you may be looking and you see that it's a PR3 and, you know, it's actually got, you know, some decent stats and stuff in other places, you know, it's pretty old, you know, this is a test site, you know, I'm not going to be trying to recover it, right, but let's say that I were, okay, let's say that this site needed to be recovered and that was important to you, then step one is figuring out what rule did you break. And if you really don't know what rule you broke, if you honestly don't, if you, you know, you did everything that you thought was completely legitimate, no trick, then you can file a reconsideration request right here and write out a long thing saying, you know, basically, I don't know why. You know, please tell me why. And what will happen is you're going to get a letter back from me, from Google, explaining why, okay? You know, they're fairly easy to work with on this, okay? So, but let's say that I know what I did, like this one, all right? I know what I did, right? Then the first thing I would do is I would take off all of the content that was duplicate / scraped / spun, and I would replace it with fresh, good, new content, all right? So give me a 4, guys, if you understand that, you know, the key to this is I'm going to find out what Google is mad at me for, and then I'm going to fix it. Give me a 4 if you get that. Okay? Give me a 5 if you understand that they give you, they tell you, straight up tell you what's wrong. Okay? Give me a five if you get that. Okay? So, you know, I got to be honest with you. This is not rocket science, and this is not like big old bad evil Google, right? This is a legitimate thing, really, in Google's eyes, right? You know, you did some stuff. You created a crappy site that has no value, so they're like, look, I'm not gonna include you in my results because there's no value here, right? So if I were going to recover this, I would get all new content for this, okay? And then I would go here, and I'd click that request a review button, okay? So, guys, give me a four if you can read these words. Give me a four if you can read these words. All right, good. All right, so I want to point out to you, if your site has been hacked, please make sure to use the Hack Site Troubleshooter, okay? So, again, you know, if this is a specific case, right, then this is something different you go to, okay? But in general, you're going to do this. Tell us how you have addressed the specific issues we have listed, okay, including all relevant information, all right? And so what you're going to do in here is you're going to say, dear sir or hello, right? And you're going to say, I understand that, you know, my site was removed from Google because I had stuff on it that was copied from somewhere else or something like that, okay? So let me look at my slide to see where I'm at. Okay, we're at the point where we say, what do you say? All right, I have recovered, I don't know how many sites that have this, and I'll tell you why. Probably, I guess it's about a year ago now, there were some major blog networks, like big ones, that were shut down, and it was horrible for a lot of crappy SEOs, but for people like me who actually do a good job, it was great because I got a flood of new clients. But a lot of these clients had these manual penalties, okay? So I had to kind of practice and get good really quick at getting fixed. So let me tell you what I do, all right? And so, you know, this is one of those things, you know, again, I don't know if this is a hashtag mind blown value or not, guys, but let me tell you how I do this, and I have had 100% success with recovering these manual penalties.
Steven,
let me say it again.
Before you continue, guys, this is so valuable what he's teaching you right now. I don't even think you understand. For those of you that are sitting here going, yeah, I know this. I've been in webmasters. I'm going to tell you, you can make a ton of money off of this for very little work. The steps that he knows and what he's done, he's able, I want you to check this out. You've went in, you've logged in, you find out what it's for, you know what, you've looked at it, you go in, you fix it, you do what he's going to tell you. How much do you think you can get from this if that site was generating thousands of dollars?
Oh, yeah.
How much do you think that you can get from that client to recover that site? Now, this is how to do it with manual penalties. Guys, we're more than thousands, John. We're like talking about, look, my pricing on this is insane. It is a third of the yearly gross that site was doing to recover this. If that site was making $1 million, I'd like guarantee you that I'm going to charge a lot of money, $10, $20, $30, $40,000 to recover this site. So guys, this is very important information. Please pay attention and don't take this lightly. You know what? I think now, if you've got any value at this whatsoever, and if you want Steven to continue, please go on there and put thanks Steven on there. We have over 300 people on there. Thanks Steven. He's showing you how you, right now, can make tens of thousands of dollars off of one client. It's a new skill. I've seen a ton of nines on there saying you've never seen a manual penalty before. He's telling you how to go in to get it done. He's given you another feather in your hat to know what to check for and how to do it. And you know what? I guarantee you Steven smiles every time he sees one of these manual penalties. Because you know what it means? It means money is raining. So guys, please, I'm going to be looking at the Facebook thread right now. Guys, I'm not seeing anything go on. I want to see some hashtag thanks Stevens go on because this is crazy. And you know what? We've only got about 30 people that bothered to even thank you, Steven. I just think we should stop. And I'm being serious, guys. Thank him for doing this. Steven's not paid for this. He's not paid to do this, guys. And I'm going to tell you something. He hasn't shared this anywhere else yet.
No, nowhere else.
Nowhere else.
Not even in my own course.
Right.
Not even in my own group.
Guys, I mean, if you think that these kids over in these black hat groups know how to do this, they don't. They don't.
No.
Steven's done this from experience. He's been around for a decade, and he's showing you something that many people have never even seen a manual penalty. So please, thank Steven for this. We want to build these things. I at least want to see 100. So if you haven't done it, guys, please, and he's going to continue. I guarantee you, you will bookmark this webinar whenever you run into a manual penalty, and you're going to desperately go by step for step with what Steven's shown you to get over this. So that's why. And I'm going to be honest with you guys. I didn't know how to do this until Steven showed me. I have no shame in saying that. No shame whatsoever. So, guys, thank him tremendously, because I don't think you're understanding what he was building up to. I know it looked a little bit slow in the beginning, but now it's turning into a freaking nuclear bomb is what it's turning into right now. And that's a way for you to get rid of a manual penalty. So looks like they're pouring in, Steven. Looks like they're pouring in.
Thanks, Kyle.
So please continue.
All right, guys, listen. So if there is an aha moment in this webinar in my portion, this is about to be it, okay? And so, I hope you get how powerful this is, because I don't know anyone personally that has 100% recoveries from manual penalties, and I know a lot of people that do SEO. So let me tell you, here's it, okay? The key to this, the key to my method is act like an idiot, okay? So that might be a good hashtag. No, I'm just joking. Don't put
hashtag idiot. Hashtag idiot.
But listen, so let me tell you, I wish I'd typed this up in advance, but let me, I'm not going to type it out because I don't type fast, but let me tell you what this request or review would look like, all right? It would look something, it would sound something like this. Sir, I understand from my web guy that you are mad at my website because I broke a rule. I don't know about these kinds of things, but he told me to change, insert whatever they put was wrong, right? Whatever they say. He told me to change the articles, and I have done that. I hope this is good enough. If not, please let me know, and if you could, please email me at my Yahoo. I mean, just, you sound like a complete, use improper terms if you talk, if you use an industry term, use the wrong one or spell it incorrectly. Here's what you want them to think, that you are an absolute idiot. Like, you have no idea what's going on here, right? That is the key to how I get these done 100% of the time. If they think you're some slick internet or SEO who's trying to recover a site that was screwing around, you're going to have a tough time. But if they think you're just some poor, innocent, you know, dupe guy who, you know, bought a website, right? Now, especially if you just bought this domain at auction or something and literally you just threw it up, then throw that in, man. Say, I just bought this on GoDuty, you know, or something. I did this and that, and you just act like a fool, basically. All right, act fool. Use incorrect terminology. Use incorrect everything. Okay, and I'll tell you what I get back is I get back these very succinct, very polite answers from Google employees. Okay, and sometimes I'll even ask questions in there. I'll even say, should I buy, you know, better photos? Or, you know, I'll ask some random, has nothing to do with this, questions, right? Again, the key here is to not look like someone who knows what they're doing. The key is to not look like you're an expert. And I'll tell you, that is the mistake that a lot of people that do this for a living supposedly make. They come in here and they talk all high and mighty, and they say, they try to look smart to Google. And they come in and they say, you know, we are unclear why you have chosen to incorrectly levy a manual penalty. We are, blah, blah, blah. Don't do that. Don't act like you're the smart guy. Act like you're the dumbass. Excuse me, the dumb guy. Okay? So, again, if there's an aha moment to this, that's it. And I know it sounds simple. And, you know, if you did it and it doesn't work, is it possible? I guess. I teach this, I use this a lot. And, again, so far, 100%. And normally these come back within just a couple of days. Okay?
That's quick.
So that's it, guys. Yeah. I mean, so what next is, after you hit this and you sent request a review, then in a couple of days you're going to get a thing back. And, oh, man, I wish I forgot to bring one. I have one. Maybe if I can find one, I'll throw it up in the group tomorrow or something. But that's one of the best emails to get back. An email back that says, congratulations. We have determined that your website no longer violates our terms, and we have, restored your visibility, something like that. I can't remember exactly what it says. But those are the good emails to get. So, so manual penalties, these are the ones that everyone's, and that's it in a nutshell.
Great stuff.
That's it.
Fletch, if you're still on, man, what do you think about this? You think you can make some money off this?
Yeah, that's the thing. It's going back to what I said earlier. I really don't focus on how I can make money. I focus on how I can deliver value. And this is huge.
Yeah.
You know, well, this is something that if someone's encountered this, and you know, I've got a couple domains that I got pretty aggressive on, and I had to figure out a way to do it, and it's huge. You know, if you've got a domain you spent some money on as an expired domain, or you got pretty aggressive with content on or whatever, this is not theory. You know, Steven logged into an account here. He showed you exactly what to do. He showed you the manual action that popped up and what it was about, and he talked about exactly what you need to say. This is not theory. This is something from someone who has done it, who's experienced it, and can help you get through it. And for somebody in, you know, kind of our position as, you know, kind of the go-between of Google and the SERPs and whatever, and then our clients, it really comes down to us being able to relay or talk about or, you know, explain the value that that inherently has. And so, yeah, this is huge. This is... this is one of the reasons that Steven is one of the very few people in the world that I trust now, to the point where if he says something, he shows it to me. I'm willing to not only do it myself, but even go so far as to kind of teach it. He's somebody that's not ever let me down. And, you know, really everything he's shown or demonstrated has been something that's in the world that works, that I have done a couple times myself, and it seems to always come through. So every time he jumps on something, I'm more than happy to just sit there with open ears and figure out how I can provide value to my clients. Mm-hmm.
You know what, Fletch? You also brought up something that's going to lead us into something else. All we've talked about is recovering client stuff. But what we've done is, guys, and for those of you that have been around OMG a while, and you know, then you'll know what I'm talking about. How many de-indexed PBNs do you have that you've never logged into Webmasters to check? And some of them are pretty powerful that you would like to get back. Think about that. Now, especially those of you that have spent money on some expensive PBNs, Steven just showed you a way that you might be able to get them back. So just
for free.
Yeah. For free. I mean, you already know how to do this right now. So, guys, please, I want you guys to show your appreciation one more time, and then Steven's going to answer some question and answers. Give me a hashtag mind blown, guys, because this isn't taught anywhere. It isn't taught anywhere. And this is something now that you've got a skill that you walked away with today that you never had when you came in here, because I know that we had all those nines that no one ever seen a manual penalty before, and no one has ever met anyone, I guarantee you, that's at 100% recovery rate with manual penalties. like Steven has. So, Derek, what do you think about this, buddy? Are you still with us?
Yeah, let me unmute myself. yeah, this is exact same tactic I love to use, too. So even with PBNs, I'll sometimes just push it to a different register and just so I can play the dummy guy who just bought a new domain. So.
yeah, get Derek. Me and Derek, we're talking about this kid. Yeah, he does it. I said, you play like a dummy? He's like, oh, yeah, I'm like the dumbest guy ever when I'm on these things.
Right.
So, man, I gotta tell you. So, you know, I love Fletch being on. I wish Fletch could be on every webinar. I know he doesn't have the time for that, but you know, I love his heart and where he comes from. And you know, to echo that, you know, I mentioned that the reason why I got good at this is other people, you know, hired SEOs. A lot of them that were unethical, you know, and they did these kind of things. You know, they used spun content. They used duplicate content. They did all the things they weren't supposed to. And these poor clients, they didn't know anything about it. You know, they you know, there's no SEO like degree, right? Not a legitimate one. So, you know, these poor people are, you know, a lot of them are just, well, all my clients. I'm not a hired gun. I don't work for just anybody that can afford me. I only work for clients and people that I believe in the product, you know, and the people. But these are people who are in trouble. You know, when they came to me, they're like, we don't know what to do. This was our livelihood. Like, you know, we have an office full of people. Like I'm going to have to lay off people. I don't know what I'm going to do. You know, they're in a panic. These are, you know, real lives. And so, you know, from a providing value point, you know, in their old company, they had no clue about this. The people that got them into the mess, as soon as there's a problem, the phones are turned off. They're not even answering texts. They like disappear. So these poor people are just hanging. And so, you know, again, coming from Fletch's perspective, you know, which is mine as well, of that providing that value, do you have any idea how long these people are going to be my – when they come on with me and 3 or 4 days later they are fixed and permanently, these people love me. And, I mean, I'm not using that term lightly. They freaking love me. You know, I'd have to work to lose them as clients, and I earned it. I deserve
that. Right.
You know, because I care about them and their well-being, and I all the decisions I make are in their best interest. You know, so again, it's cool for all kinds of different things. You know, but think about it from the client perspective. You know, a lot of times this can be night and day for them. You know, literally, I had a couple of guys. One of them had like it was a roofing company. And, you know, he had like 10 employees and, you know, it was a family-owned business. And he was like, I mean, it was a grown man who was almost in tears. He didn't know what to do. You know, he was about to lose his business like his dad built. You know, his like father built this business over like 30 years and he was about to lose it. You know, and we were able to get it back in, you know, days. Anyway, sorry, I didn't want to harp. It's just, you know.
No, it's powerful stuff.
This stuff is real. You know, this is real to me. You know, it's very real to me. When you help people like that, you know, again, it's great to be the person that does that. It's that feeling is better than the money, honestly. You know, I might not agree, but the feeling of helping people is just so awesome. And again, as far as a client retention, you know, perspective, forget about it. So anyway, sorry, I didn't mean to go on a rant.
No, man, it's like great. But one of the things you've also showed us is this cost a whole nothing. You can do this for free. It costs $0. There's no tool that needs to be bought. There's no extra money that needs to get spent. And now you've not only taught them to do something to check their own PBNs, but clients' PBNs, and now they have the skill that they've walked away with that now they can put food in their family's table. So even thank you for sharing that with all of us. I'd like to know that I have never did a manual penalty myself, and now because of you, I know. So that's why we have you around, man, and you're absolutely the best. So, guys, please, if you haven't had a chance to, you know, let Steven know that you appreciate him. Steven, you know, could be with his family right now. He could be doing a lot of stuff. If you enjoy him on these webinars, I, like, love to get him every time he gets a chance to come on. And, you know, and he just doesn't do this for anybody. Steven goes to events and like, people are hounding at him. You know, hey, can you give me a review here? Can you give me a review there? So he's literally in my mind in one of the top five SEOs in the world. And I will say that, and you'll hear that coming out of my mouth. So he's always a pleasure to have on here. So
I appreciate it. I get paid in all my other groups, guys. Just right. So you know, I get paid a good amount of money. But I love being an OMG. I love being so much. That's why I love sharing, because I love being a member. It's this community is not like anything else. And again, we all know that, right? I think we all know what we're in. I think we all got it.
Exactly. And so guys, if you haven't had a chance to thank him, please do so. Steven, do you have anything else you need to add to this, or are we all done?
No, that's it. I'll make sure that I put the PowerPoint up or whatever. So if anybody wants the slides, you know, I'll make sure they get them.
Great. That's Bible stuff. Guys, next week, April Fool's Day. Man, I just try to keep coming at you as hard as I can with all of the best information possible. I can tell you right now, we do know and have confirmed next week's guest. Guys, give me a number one if you know who Alexander Becker is. Give me one, exactly. Guys, Alexander Becker, better known as Becker, my good buddy, is going to be our guest next week on Assimilation Webinar, and he is going to blow your mind with a Facebook ads lesson on how to get SEO clients. And guys, listen, Becker doesn't understand, and he doesn't know, because he's busy, all of this stuff and how crazy we've been getting with all these webinars and OMG. Guys, I want you to do me a favor. There's still 300 people on here. Guys, I want us to go over there, and I want you to tag Alex Becker, not Alexander Becker, Alex Becker. I want you to tag him in that thread if you're excited about him being here next week. I can tell you this, Alex doesn't show up anywhere or do anything unless you're a close friend or unless you got $25,000 for a speaking appearance or that. He's going to be throwing down here next week. I want you to show him that you're excited about him being here. So I want you to tag Alex Becker. Tag him and let him see that we're talking about in here, and that you're excited about him being here next week, because I literally believe that he's going to blow your mind. I've seen some of the stuff he's doing with Facebook, and I know that you guys also want to get an edge on how to get clients. I'm trying to show you an edge each week. Alex is a master at this sort of stuff. And here's the kicker to all this. We're going to fly up with Alex on the 1st. Well, guys, the 8th, just a week later, yes, I have our guest booked for that as well. Guys, that is none other than a 19-year-old phenom. His name is Wyatt Workowski.
Wyatt.
Wyatt the Riot, man. He's come out with Cloud PBN. He does this. But I'm going to tell you what Wyatt is amazing at. He's amazing at retargeting.
Amen.
Guys, if you don't know what retargeting is, he's going to blow your freaking mind. And he's going to follow that back up. So, guys, we're taking client getting and we're taking how to get these other people's attention to another level. So we're going out, bringing in top guns. You guys know that Alex, Becker produces a lot of people in here. And secondly, Wyatt Wachowski, in my opinion, he very well. Him and Alexander Becker, I think it's going to be a tie of who could be the greatest internet marketer that ever lived. I mean, Alex Becker's just 27 years old, and look at what he's done. And I've got almost 20 years on him. Alex has got 20 years to be better than me or Steven or anyone else. Think of what he's going to do as young as he is. Wyatt is 19 years old, and I learned from him immensely. So that's going to be exciting as well. And then the week after that, guys, I'm going to be live at Network Empire Certification, and we're going to try to get Jimmy on live. I said try. And we're going to try to get Sue, Russell, and Fletch will be there with me. I know that if anyone will be live with me, I know Fletch will. Fletch won't turn me down. But, guys, if you're excited about finding out Network Empire, you know how crazy they are, how powerful they are. If you'd like to get Jimmy on that webinar, along with Fletch, tag Jimmy and Fletch in this right now also. Let them know that you're excited about getting them on that webinar. So I've got the next 3 weeks planned out for you. Alex Becker, Wyatt Wachowski, and then I'm going to be at Network Empire Certification with Fletch, Mike Hayden, Jimmy Kelly, Russell Wright, Sue Bell, and I'm just anxious to hang out with Fletch and have a few beers. What do you say, Fletch?
Well, I'm rarely one to, you know, shy away from a couple beers, Cotton, especially with you, my friend. But, yeah, I'll be ready. I've been training.
So, you've been training?
Going to be live. So, but yeah, it's really, you know, we're not trying to contrive how much fun we actually have together. We truly like one another. We respect one another. Not just Cotton and I, Steve in the same place. Becker is, for the screwball he seems to be in a lot of ways, he is one of the few people I truly am honored. I got to open both of the last OMG Live events with him, mm-hmm. and he's somebody that I truly feel as different as we may seem, he is all about being able to deliver value to his clients. So the people that you have opened up to here with OMG and just, you know, getting to learn from folks who are trying it, who are figuring out what works and what doesn't and, you know, passing that along. Mm-hmm. Becker's one of those. And, you know, he gets to be fun and, you know, sit on his Lamborghini and have his cool forearm tattoos and whatever. But he knows what works and he passes it along to people. So, he's a good cat, and I will definitely tune in for his right. you know, session next week and whatnot. So
anything can happen when like Becker shows up. Anything can happen. Mm-hmm. So
for sure.
Yeah, guys, just a quick recap of all we went over today. We had an amazing questions and answers. I've went and I've shown you how to do video email, how it can impact your business. As Fletch said, how it can provide value, how you yourself and your personality can come through, get inside the email and actually show people that you care. Then Steven has went over and shown you possibly one of the most mind-blowing things that we've done through all assimilation webinars, how to remove a manual penalty, how that can provide value for the owners, but not only that, how you also can even check your PBNs and how this can be another money-getting arsenal that you have in your bat utility belt. I mean, guys, if we were Batman, we would have so many gadgets going around us right now. We're going to keep coming at you. Facebook ads next week, retargeting the week after that. God knows what we're going to try to come up with, Fletch, but something tells me with being at CERT, we're going to have some crazy stuff to share with them. So. But,
yeah, that week is like a big factor. I have a feeling you and I both, and you know, Mike Hayden being over here from Australia, and the rest of the people that are there, in addition to actually Network Empire, who live like 12 miles away from me, that for the reason that they're always testing and trying things, I've still not ever met them here in town. I live ridiculously close, and they're always doing stuff. So I'm really looking forward to that week, and. Yeah, getting to go live with whoever we can pull out of that is going to be epic.
Definitely. Yeah. So, guys, it's been fun. We have been able to take you to a full 3 hours. Guys, please thank Steven, Fletch, Derek. Derek is always amazing with his time being here, guys. You know what? Derek never gets any love, and I don't like it. Let's give a hashtag thanks, Derek. You know, you know what? Guys, please thank Derek. He's never missed an assimilation webinar. He doesn't have to be here. I totally, totally would never want to do a webinar without him, guys. If you want Derek to keep coming back and get his knowledge and he keeps dropping on us, please, guys, come on here and think like Derek. You know, he just comes on and drops his knowledge. And it's always great to have someone as amazing as Derek. I told you guys from the very first webinar, Derek was going to be one of the most up and coming and brilliant SEOs that you've never met yet. And he's proven it time and time again, again. And guys, listen, if you need some coaching, one-on-one coaching, Derek, are you accepting any?
Yes, I am currently open for some private consultations.
Guys, I'm going to be honest with you. There's only a few people that I would recommend to you. And all of them are on this webinar right now. And Derek is one of them. If you need one-on-one coaching, if you're struggling, And Derek is still affordable right now, because I'm telling you, the rate with these assimilation webinars and what we're doing and what we're going on, Derek could skyrocket to the $1,000 an hour range very easily. He's nowhere near that right now. Or maybe he is. I don't even know. I don't even know what the prices are. Contact, message Derek right now. Message him if you're interested in some one-on-one coaching from Derek. I guarantee you that he'll blow your freaking mind. Derek is always – yes.
Can I jump?
Yes.
Guys, I mean, I've talked to Derek like all the time. I can't imagine like a better coach. If you – I mean, seriously, like we were – he was just messing around. We were just messing around one time a couple of weeks ago, and he knocked a client site like from nothing to like page two in like 4 days. Like, and he was just like giggling, like just – I mean, he's crazy good. I know I don't have to pitch
There's that up. Laugh, man. There's that laugh.
I just got to tell you. I mean, seriously, I can't even believe he's doing coaching. I mean, it's crazy. So if you need it, man, that's where I go.
Guys, and the last thing I'm going to do before I go is, Fletch is on here, Steven's on here, Derek, I'm on here. Guys, if you haven't friended us on Facebook, and if you ever want to ask us a question, if you're not my friend, they all go to my other box. Guys, if you haven't friended me and you're on the webinar, do so. If you haven't friended Derek, do so. If you haven't friended Fletch, do so. Steven, friend us. We answer questions. We like try to do whatever we can. I don't want you to think that I'm ignoring you. I do not want you to think that I'm ignoring you, that I'm avoiding your questions. I do not ever look at the other inbox, but maybe once every 2 months. So it's okay to friend us. If that's why we're here in OMG, then your questions can come directly to us. We might not get to your questions right away. But whenever we have time, I'd like to set aside about an hour and a half every day to help OMGers answer questions, get on with Skype with someone, help someone out. So I have that allocated in my time. So please, if you got questions, guys, friend us. Just go through and do the list. Fletch, Derek, Steven, me, friend us. Because I don't want your questions thinking that we're ignoring you or that we're too important to talk to you. That's not what OMG is about. I always have time to help out people. I know Fletch does too. I know Steven does whatever he can, and I know Derek will as well. Remember, Derek's offering personal coaching. If you need it, I would recommend you doing it. If you're struggling or having a hard time ranking, he will definitely get you over the hump with anything you need. So guys, with that, we are right at 3 hours, and I will see you next week with Alexander Becker. Thank you very much. Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Todd. Thank you so much, buddy. We'll see you next time.
Bye, guys.
All right, buddy.
Have a good night, guys.
All right, bye.